Because I was really fouling. I have to make paper cuts. My hand gets dried.
Yeah, actually, that's a big problem for me, is that like my hands just get kind of dried, I guess. I don't know.
Well, that's enough of a...
And nobody in the stream knows what we're talking about. Hi!
Well, that's enough of them. Enough of that.
Should probably,
okay.
Like, tweet this or something. You know, because, like, oh man, Twitter is a 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 Twitter. Hey! Twitter! Here's a link you should maybe click on if streams are your thing. Yo.
If they ever had a function on Twitter where they read the tweets out loud to you, that's what it should sound like. Just that slow and annoying.
I agree, actually. I legitimately agree.
Kid, this is why you should read you should read the tweets instead of having them read to you.
No, go away. Stop. Everything. What? Stop. No. Come on. I'm gonna sneeze. Okay. Okay. At least I warned you. Gosh. Man, I killed my little stream preview thing on accident.
Dang, God. Why did you do that?
Okay, there we go. I got it back. Yay! Start button! Yay, X button! Yay, X button! Yay, up button! Yay, X button! Yay, X button! I'm just going to announce every single button I push. This cannot possibly end badly. Ever. Clearly.
Yeah, you won't annoy anybody.
I won't annoy anybody at all, ever. What are you talking about?
I know, right. What do I do for me to ever answer back?
No, it's only been 19 minutes. Give him another minute.
Triangle button. X
yeah,
button.
Leave him another minute.
Right button, no. X button.
Game guy, really? Am I gonna have to... Is this gonna be the whole stream? Whatever.
Hey, man.
It'll be annoying at first, and then you'll try to say it, then something will happen, and you'll try to say it, and then it'll get really funny all of a sudden.
I know, right? X button! Oh, I didn't do anything.
And then you'll hit a button that does nothing. From the planet of Kronos, where
Commander Shellshock and his army have taken over the city. Commander Shellshock, I love that guy. Ratchet will fight to keep Team Darkstar alive, while Clink tries not to get him lost. What? Clink? Clank? Well, Clank, that's what I said. Well, you know, it doesn't matter, because Team Darkstar is about to become Team Deadstar.
Okay, I had to retweeted. Something, but yeah. We'll be there to finish them off for good. Place your bets,
everybody, because we're going straight to the action. Man, Dallas makes all the best puns. Did you hear that one? He's all like, Team Darkstar is going to be like Team Deathstar. Star Wars.
I made a stupid pun at the end of my English essay, actually. According to my nav grid, the spotlights are it's on purpose, though.
Good luck, Ratchet. Good luck from Clank Guy. Clank Guy said good luck to me, guys. I feel happy. Ugh. You know, it still annoys me that I can't shoot through the shields with the turret. It really kind of does. I mean, to a point, it makes sense, but why am I even using that turret? I don't even know, man. Oh man, I leveled up the the shield launcher. It's pretty great. Why, again, I keep losing my multiplier magically, and I don't really understand why or how. Also, I guess maybe like I only get like stat boosts on weapons and such if I level it up every 10 levels or something. That's just weird.
Come on! Would somebody just kill this little one? Could you lose it if you don't hit anything for like X amount of time or something?
I don't know. Also, what?
What?
The problem I have now is I don't have any long-range weapons that I can use. I need to get a long-range something or other.
You should try to buy one.
Well, that's probably what I'm gonna buy next. But right now, I have popcorn to eat, so y'all better just sit back and relax.
Ratchet. Don't do that. Oh, whatever.
But... No, say whatever, say awesome.
But whatever, he's a Lombax. Well, I was gonna say he's a Lombax, so maybe he has more than one life. Well, don't obviously.
Well, yeah, because I keep just coming right on back.
Yeah.
Oh, man, Mega Stark.
He has infinite lives.
Oh, man, these guys are hot.
And as I'm discovering from this game, he has infinite weapons.
Well, yeah. Actually, for the most part, I only have three at this point, because I'm just using three. But you
I know. Well, I was just gonna say that because looking at the list of weapons that were shown, it looked like there was a lot of freaking weapons.
There's only like, what, 10 in here? Like, there's 8 on this first thing, and then there's the mini thing. Yeah, there's only 10.
There's only 10.
I just don't have the 10th one because it's the super weapon that costs a lot. Oh man.
Oh man. Might want to totally get that.
Where am I supposed to go? I don't even remember.
It's funny because you in the game I'm playing, that's what I was about to ask. Well, except I think I have an indication, so.
That guy said funny things.
Oh man. Wait, what? Nothing. It's really awkward in a game where you walk in a room and all of a sudden a counter appears.
Which counter?
It's a counter with a 9 and has a purple thing with a red eye.
Oh. I don't know what we're talking about, so.
Do you?
I don't. That's why I said I don't know what we're talking about.
Oh, hold on. I think I know what I'm supposed to do.
Oh, geez. I thought the mission was over, so I just kind of kept walking forward, and there was a guy there. Hi, guy there. How are you?
Geez, game guy.
What in the... Oh, that's how I know I'm doing good. The thing has a health bar next to it.
Hey! Mr. Quark guy, you can, like, go away or whatever. That'd be great.
Too bad the turret I'm operating doesn't. Okay, I gotta
go. Come on, get closer. Thank you! Thank you! Okay, goodbye.
No, I can't This guy really awkward. The game guy is streaming a Ratchet game and I'm playing a Jack game. This is like Total Rivals here, man.
Total Rivals!
Well, I don't...
But now, I never really played the Jack series. Only the game I only played was Daxter, but I don't consider that part of the series in a way.
It's a spin off more than anything.
Yeah.
Team Dark Star is unstoppable!
Yay!
Okay, what is launching lasers at me?
Hey, hey, Merc, shut up. The challenge is over, go away.
Okay, so there's a flower there. Oh, what? Oh, of course, the enemies have taken over the fucking guns, that's nice.
Yay!
Well, I was like, why are the turrets I'm supposed to be using firing at me? Right, because the enemies in this game somehow know how to operate giant guns.
I kind of want the dual raptors, actually.
Anyway. Let's try...
Yeah, I want the dual raptor. It's an easier, longer range weapon. Something I'll probably end up using a fair bit anyway.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the one, the only.
Better try my long range weapon too here.
Oh man, it's a guy.
No. Fire the weapon.
I don't want to die. I want to live. Oh yeah, you're that stupid guy that has
the hell?
Stupid attack.
This is so much fun, you know?
The most fun.
I used to know Jack's so damn slow that he can't outrun a turret that's firing at him.
Well, yeah, you expected him to outrun it? Because, that's silly of you.
Well, there's really no way to take it down besides... Oh, well... I can always hide behind this rock and use my weapon too. That would be a good idea.
And then the rock moves lightly to the right.
Turkey, that would mean I'd be more protected.
Yay, I win!
Then it moves back to the left and kills you.
Okay, where is this guy? Okay, there he is.
He's over there, Bobby.
God, no, you fired, Jack, you fired the weapon the wrong way.
Enemies are such a grind.
Team Dark Star must now traverse a grind.
I don't even know if that guy died.
Feet above the water. Is that even safe? Of course it's not. This is Dread Zone, baby.
Actually, this is more or less the reason why I kind of wanted the thing, but all right. By the thing, I mean like a gun of some kind that can shoot bullets. Yes, a gun of some kind that can shoot bullets. What of it? Oh, blah, blah.
Oh, great, thanks.
My map shows that this is an excellent spot to use the Hollow Shield launcher.
Wonderful design there, guys.
This is an excellent spot to use the Hollow Launcher Shield.
Now let me get in this friggin' turret.
The problem is, by the time I level up all the rest of my weapons, I'm gonna be like done leveling up these.
Jump onto the grind rail to traverse this gap.
Okay, there should be one more. Okay, there we go.
There we go. Hey guys, I just walked off the edge, you know, no biggie.
Just keep walking. Gravity will kill you.
I'm pretty good at this game, guys. I have to say.
Okay. That's great, game back.
It is
good job.
Great. Man, you are you suggesting you could do better? Because I don't think you could. I mean, that's some grade A platforming right there.
Jump onto the grind. Oh, come on. Weapons they want me to free and use for this.
So wacky.
Yeah, maybe a homing weapon. Let's try that.
See, here's my problem. I don't have an upgrade to this weapon, so I'm more or less a sitting duck. Yeah, this is gonna go well.
What? I disabled that gun. What the heck? Would you? Fucking seriously, what the hell?
Man, I'm not sure what to do in this here situation, because I want the dual rapitar things, and I'm not anywhere close to getting said things. It's the only thing I can use on grind rails for some reason. It's not even that great of a weapon, to be honest.
Okay, this is where I need to go. Great.
I really would like to know why my multiplier keeps randomly going down.
Oh my god, shut up! Mother of God, what in the world?
By the way, the multiplier is usually when you get hit, right?
I'm sorry, what? Ah, go away, sneezes, no one likes you. Say again, now that I'm not distracted by bodily functions.
Usually your multiplier goes away if you get a hit.
Well, that's the thing. I don't think I'm getting hit. So
I don't know. There's a time effect to it, which I doubt there would be.
What am I even supposed to do here? Because these guys are just gonna shoot me. Freaking heck, man. This is not gonna go well. I'm doing amazing, by the way. Just gonna get hit by those guys every single time I enter this challenge. It's gonna be great.
Oh, boy.
Like, see, right there, I just lost my multiplier for no reason, and I didn't get hit. Like, what the heck? Please tell me I'm not the only one who, like, sees this happening.
I don't know what... Well, it could be.
Actually, a thought occurs for this weapon here. Can I change my... Well, no, not... I may want the freeze mod on this thing temporarily so that they can slow down. Giving me a chance to, you know, live. Or whatever. Actually, that doesn't seem to have any remote effect. What's that? He is an animal? Yeah, I knew that. See, because I would think that using the ice mod would, like, freeze the guys, make it easier to slow them down so they can't shoot me, but apparently not. Ugh, freaking heck. So this is going fantastic. Get away, guy. Okay, well, let me do this then. And press X to enter the alpha modification menu. Multiple alpha mods of the same type. I don't need the jackpot mod, that can go away.
A pool of available upgrades for each weapon will appear above the bottom.
Oh man.
Impact mod. An alpha mod at any time. Isn't there one that like increases damage, or am I just not?
Okay, anyway, well, I'm playing as a bad guy now.
Don't do that, Bobby. That's unsafe.
It's forced. What does this do?
Just increase the speed. Maybe that'll help out. I don't know. Let's try a shock mod, I guess.
That was the world's worst six.
Hey man, I'd love to stop dying, except the problem is, this part is kind of silly. This is forcing me to use a weapon that I don't have the mega version of yet, and I should have realized this was going to become an issue. Oh, Jesus. Guy's there, and I'm not even paying attention to him. Awesome. Will you stop shooting? Like, this is the most annoying thing. Any weapon other than this one. Could I use any weapon other than this one? Okay, you know what, actually, hold on. I don't want to do this, but dang it, this is getting stupid. No. I want to quit. Back to the title screen. I'm going to put this on a lower difficulty just for this challenge, because apparently I can't do anything until I have that stupid freaking thing. I'm not gonna sit here and just try it forever and ever. That'd be dumb. In case you don't know. Oh, I still have the shock mod on there. That hasn't been helping me in the slightest.
What's your favorite weapon in the game?
The one that doesn't suck.
Or any of the Ratchet and Clank games.
Man, I don't know. There's too many good ones.
Morphorite is pretty good. I know that. It's funny. Giant.
The brainwash mod doesn't help in the slightest. Wow, this is just not going well. I was probably better off with the acid mod. Like, what the heck am I even supposed to do?
Hey boss, do you reach awesome?
Jump onto the grind rail to traverse this gap.
No, not challenges, weapons, thank you. Maybe I do need that auto-aim thing. There's enough ammo on this thing that ammo shouldn't even be an issue.
But in this game, I'm sure there is. I'm not excited about really watching LP because it's a computer problem. Do you get like a little robot dude following you?
Yeah. Thank you for dying. Hey, I'm potentially making progress here. It's amazing how that works.
Excuse me.
Hooray! I win!
Yay!
The action's heating up as Team Darkstar lights up the spotlights that will unlock the Dark Cathedral of Kronos.
A treacherous
path lies ahead as Dread Zone's deadliest warriors will be waiting to ambush them. Oh, baby, I love this job.
Okay, let's do this thing again. Save the game. Quit the game. Remind me that the first thing I need to buy is the freaking dual raptor thing, guys. If I had realized that, like, last time, I might have bought those first, just because these grind rail sections are gonna be painful if I don't. Ugh, jeez.
What?
Freaking, why are you so expensive? Bah! Whoosh! Oh no, another dropship. When did this happen? Oh, hi there, guy. I kind of killed you or whatever. What? How did popcorn happen anyway? I was right next to health. Why did I die? That's not fair.
Oh, man.
Rough. Then everything kinda died. The end. I love it when everything kinda dies. The end. It's pretty great.
The announcer is impressed.
Oh man, there's a that guy over there. I'm stuck against this random, not even a wall. It's pretty great. Doop-a-doo, shooting all the guys in the world. Hi, guys in the world, how are you today? Do you want to die, maybe? That'd be cool. Yay, I can go over here. Hey guy, like, die please, thank you, okay. Yay, everybody's dying or something. This is gonna become silly, cause I'm gonna run out of, like, weapons or something here. Or, well, no, I'm not gonna run out of weapons, it's more like I've just been using these exclusively, so... Oh man, level 40.
Why are people asking if the call's dead?
Is the call dead? I mean,
no.
You guys aren't really talking.
No, the call is dying! No!
Anyway, I'm joking about that, but yeah.
Yay, I win!
Of course, we only get, what, the three of us in the call right now?
Well, it's about to be four.
Oh man!
Wait, for me to answer you?
No.
Yes,
Cam would be added.
That Australian guy? Jeez.
Whoever said getting into that cathedral was easy? I did? Well, that was then and this is now, huh? Team Darkstar will have to fight their way through a series of increasingly deadly arenas. Bet they didn't see that coming.
You guys want to hear a joke?
Does it involve Daddy Flakes?
Well, no, I'll see if you want to hear a joke. I didn't have one.
Oh. Well, Cam! Why?
Maybe you want to hear one. I would have looked up one for you and been like, man, this is a funny joke. Let's read it out to Game Guy. I'm just here to make you happy. Come on, man. I love you. It's kind of hard to find compassion while you're destroying scrubs.
By a cruise missile in the Obani Moon War. His brain was later replaced with an AI chip taken from a coffee machine. As a result, he is totally impervious to pain.
Just shooting things. This is like Toho, this boss. It's like I'm really playing Toho.
It is. It's exactly like Toho. Come on, give a sneeze again. Ah, jeez.
Bless you.
Oh,
man, I'm
back.
Sneezing a lot today. What up with that?
Jeez, Mitch said you sneeze weirdly. You're gonna take that?
Yeah.
Okay. Mitch, you get off scot free. There you go.
Oh my.
So why? If I was you, Game Guy, I would have just punched him through the internet, and he would have been like, "Ow!" You'd have been like, "Dang right, done, tootin'."
Oh yeah, I should probably like refill my ammo or whatever. Hey there, turret guy. You're pretty cool. Man, I love these dual raptors and how powerful they are. Look how powerful that thing was. Like, I totally killed that guy, like, all super fast and whatnot. You see that?
viewers could feel that one in Bogan, Juanita. I'd rate it at least a 7 out of 9.
At not least.
10. And this is a scale that people use too much.
Oh, well.
Shit.
By the way, I'm pretty close to dying.
Oh man, I still don't get why they changed. Like, I do get it, but it's like 84 units of health rather than just having the simple nanotech that they did before.
Wait, what?
Interesting, I guess.
Might be a good spot for a grind, Cable Boss. You don't get what now?
I never feel that. Oh man.
Of course, you know, I actually haven't gotten, like, max health yet. It's for some reason that's something I haven't been able to do yet.
Huh. I'm guessing max health is, like, 99.
It's... well, I think in challenge mode it's 200, but I didn't even get to the max of 100 in not challenge mode.
Oh wow. 200. Jeez. You would surely have to have, like, extra upgrades to reach 200 as well, though. Like, you can have a level cap and then have a couple of upgrades to reach. Are there any health upgrades, as in, you know, customizable health upgrades?
I think you get different armor as you progress through the game that just increases your defense, but that's not really the same thing, I guess.
Oh, okay. Because I never actually watched the whole Let's Play of Deadlock.
Oh man, I'm a sitting duck on grind rails. It's pretty great. Look at me, I'm a duck that can sit. Ducks are.
If Kraydon was here right now, he'd just be yelling at you, telling you to stop getting dumped.
Yeah, if Kraydon were here right now, he'd be Kraydon. Wow, that thing did a lot of damage.
Well, at least there's guns in the game. He'd be like, well, at least just we're playing Call of Duty, but it's not exactly Call of Duty. There's still a gun.
Oh, man. So this weapon is doing a pretty good job, gotta say.
Boss, when this is all over, I'd like you to get.
Wow, that thing hits me, like, really well, and it's annoying. Will one of you freaking EMP already, please? That'd be great. I pressed the EMP command, like, ages ago. Thank you. Gosh. I'm sitting here, like, dodging death. You're just sitting there, not doing anything.
I'm just sitting here all dead.
Bobby, don't do that.
Yeah, if you die, then you'll be dead. That's not good.
Yeah, being dead is not cool, man.
But then it won't be as much fun.
Yeah. Come on, if you die, I'm gonna be very mad at you.
Yeah.
You will not like that.
You don't want to see the mad Australian.
What?
I guess this is a bad time to mention that I'm afraid of heights.
What?
Do anything. Don't blame me, game guy.
It's okay, Cam.
Then came the man that gets on a plane, flies over, goes to Genghis' house, and makes him safe.
Yeah, I'd probably just bring a giant machete and just use my ninja skills.
Change part of your face.
And then actually, it'd be worth the flight, yeah?
So, Game Guy, apparently I've got this awesome team.
Awesome
of
team.
Daxter, Jackson, Jack and Daxter somehow. That's exactly how you said it, by the way. There's two Daxters.
Two Daxters? Yowza, dude.
He's like, we're a team of three. I'm like,
Oh, what, you didn't know that? You didn't know that Daxter counted as two people? Because I'm pretty sure Daxter counts as two people.
Oh god, this thing. Oh my god, this thing operates horribly. What?
What? I freaking jumped to the right, not to the what?
That's interesting. Please tell me more.
I do it. Do.
EMP. It's dynamite. EMP. Well, it's not actually dynamite. It's an electromagnetic pulse that's used to disable robotics.
The electromagnetic sounds cooler, so that must be the name.
Do what now?
Isn't that how it works?
It's just all like, man, I'm gonna like electromagnetic pulse you, and then you're just gonna glitch out and not work anymore.
What? Nothing hit him.
The end.
Whoa. I guess this is a bad time to mention that I'm afraid of heights.
This is a bad time to mention you're afraid of heights, Mr. Robot Guy. Also, you're a robot, so the fact that you have fears is a little weird, but, you know, whatever.
We are out of range, aren't we?
We need to get across that gap, sir! Permission to deploy a grind rail!
Why are you talking about deploying a grind rail when I've already done that? Man, you are so behind. I will say, I do like how after it decided to add this ricochet thing that like all these shots go flying everywhere now. It does look pretty cool. It's like it bounces off of one enemy and then hits another!
Yeah,
it's like
this
magic.
Is a really fair mission, totally.
I'm sorry, what?
Nothing.
Well, I just remembered I'm Australian, so I'm gonna go cry for a bit, VRB.
Cam, no.
But yes. Why?
Because I want a drink of water, and I didn't think of anything else witty to say.
Does the grind rail section have to be, like, near the end? Because, I mean, that's cool.
Oh, come.
Oh man.
What? Yeah, excuse any random complaints for the next few minutes.
Oh, but why? I'm not excusing anything.
Because I'm doing a mission that has two extremely unfair things about it.
Oh, I guess this is a bad time to mention that I'm afraid.
Let's get an 88% to win.
Well, one, the enemy that I'm supposed to be defending this ship, which has dynamite on it.
I love dynamite!
Which is nice because enemies can attack the ship before you ever see them.
Team Darkstar simply won't give up!
So you almost have to memorize their locations or else you're screwed.
It's cool that they let you use the guns on the grind rails and whatnot, but it's not cool that they're not really that great.
And then there's a couple other stupid things about it. Oh boy, watch, like there's gonna be an enemy right over here that I won't see.
There's gonna be one behind a rock.
No, there's a couple that are hiding in water though that you can't see until the last second.
That's always
see, this is a problem. I wish they would fire at me instead of the thing I'm transporting.
Isn't that like the mission or something?
Because I have, like, full health, so... Oh, and then random missiles come flying in the picture. Really slowly, apparently. Okay, how many are being fired, though? And why are they barely on the damn screen? Oh god, two robots. Oh, good, I shot that guy before I even saw him.
So apparently jumping like a maniac is the solution to getting hit constantly, because then they can't hit you.
No, let me shoot those guys. I know those guys are going to cause problems. Please make it, please make it. No,
shut your face!
More. Why is there more?
Why is that like the only thing I can say to my watch now? It's just, shut your face! I mean, it was funny the first time, and now it's just like, man... Pretty much the same thing. Inside the dark cathedral of Kronos.
It's cold, it's stank, it's scary, it's just oh, like really? And I have to block missiles and enemies. That's nice. And why are you flying this way? Is about to plaster them all over these
cathedral walls. Yeah, I'm noticing that the viewers today are like way down for some reason. I guess people don't like the Ratchet Deadlocks game. I don't know.
Can I? Oh god, more missiles. And I can't.
Did you know that Shell Shock was recently named the sexiest robot alive by Vox magazine?
No. Ah! Where'd you come from? Like, literally, this guy wasn't here a second ago, and now he's suddenly here.
Oh, there's a checkpoint. Good.
10 billion Shell Shock things.
Otherwise, this mission would be impossible, because. You have to, well, and I don't know why he flies in a circle around the Haven City instead of going straight to the place he needs to go, but whatever.
This is the part where I die or whatever.
Well, I mean, some of this stuff you can shoot in advance, technically speaking, but... Whoa, god, missiles. Which are insta-kill, unfortunately, so you gotta make sure you take care of this.
Ha! I blew that thing up with a shield. I bet you guys didn't blow anything up with a shield. Look at that. I blew that thing up with a shield. Sneezes, go away! No one likes you. Do I have gravity boots? No. I never did go and see what was up there, if anything. I don't suspect there's anything up there, though.
Hey, game guy, I wrote a haiku about you. Do you want me to read it to you?
Yeah!
I need this. Please. I'll read it out to you, anyway. Just because I can. I don't think you're ready. Let me just read it out. Game guy 888. Always play this video game. Really needs to shave.
Aw, that's beautiful. Also, I got popcorn.
There you go. I'll just post in the Skype chat for you to read when you're sad.
Okay.
Cheer you up on the saddest day. Aw, oh, man.
Okay, we're almost. Okay, almost finished this.
What's the game plan, the next game? I'm too lazy to go check YouTube channel.
Pikmin is the next game, but this one's gonna take a while, so I probably won't get that far tonight.
Oh, okay.
Thankfully, I'm gaining like a whole lot of bolts or whatever. That's pretty cool.
Oh, there we go.
Initiate annihilation program. I call this one my dishonorable discharge.
It's almost over, folks.
Target acquired.
terminated with extreme prejudice.
Freaking, these little guys, like, go away, please. It's making it very hard to do anything. Go away, stupid little fast guys. I don't like you. Well, okay, thank you.
I call this one my dishonorable discharge. I get the quiet.
Oh man, this is what I call the shield strategy. It's the strategy where I use shields a whole bunch and can't possibly really get hit.
You know, the disappointing thing about this game is that when you're streaming it, it's just pew pew pew, so there's nothing interesting that I can think to say.
You can think of some things to say, Cam. You just gotta be creative.
And he was holding to riding a hike before you.
Oh, I upgraded the shield! By the way. I like how I'm just kind of standing around in a bunch of explosions, not getting hit or anything. It's pretty great. Oopsie! Oh no, he dropped his cigar again. Also, I put my helmet back on just for that cutscene, just so you know. It's like, oops, I killed a guy, better put my helmet back on and watch him die. Oh, he's dead, well, I'm gonna take it off again.
Didn't you know Ratchet was a professional magician?
I should have known that.
He has a TV show and everything.
Is that what this is about?
Yeah. It's not even about the Dread Zone or any of that. Garbage, it's just Ratchet practicing his magic tricks.
I knew it. So yeah, the fact that he has all these weapons
on, everyone celebrates. He's look at the shot, guys. He's so happy about it. He's impressed. He's so impressed, he's mad.
He's just jealous of my magical skills.
And see, Ace Hardlight is just a washed up magician. You can't even do any card tricks anymore.
Aww.
It's just so bad.
Card tricks are the easiest magic.
I know.
He's even more popular than you were back in your heroic youth. Come to think of it, he even reminds me of you. I said he got lucky. His luck won't last forever. My luck will totally last forever. You see how good I was at all of those missions? Gosh, man.
Oh, I remember that cutscene from Let's Play of this video game. Where Ace Hardlight gets mad and butt munched. And he bashes the desk for no reason. Also, suddenly Star Fox.
I know, right? Oh yeah, these hover ship missions were really good for getting bolts on.
Man, the controls look really wonky on that ship. Is that true, or is it just look
yeah,
wonky for no
reason?
Yeah, it
is kind of wonky. Like, spoiler alert, I went back to play up your arsenal so I could do the what if video for that, and I had to do hover ship missions, and I'm like, oh my gosh, these are so much better controls. It's so annoying.
Yeah. From where I'm sitting as well, it looks a bit too floaty and ugh.
Well, like, you control the reticle with the right stick, which is fine, but it also kind of angles you in a different way, so, like, whichever way you're angled, you'll start going up or down. It's just kind of confusing.
Yeah. Yeah, that's weird.
Furthermore, one thing that I really disagree with is the fact that, like, with the old hover ship from up your arsenal, you'd press X to go up. Now X goes down. It's just really annoying.
Continuation, everybody.
No, this game does not know how to continuity at all. Because they went back to the old style of controls in the next game anyway, so it's just like, oh, good. Not that the next game had a hover ship, but at least I don't think it did. I don't remember.
Did you ever get the Ratchet & Clank remix for the PS3?
Oh, yeah, I did.
Do you like them?
It's okay. It's like the same game, so it's not like there's anything really wrong with it, but there's a few random little glitches graphically with a lot of it.
That's weird.
And other assorted random glitch type things.
You'd think that it wouldn't be too hard to fix that sort of thing due to all the work going into that rather than storyline, etc.
I think part of it is, like, I don't know if anyone's seen those developer commentary videos that some guys have been putting out about the Ratchet games. I forget what their channel's called. I don't know. I'll try to look for it later. But, like, they're basically saying something along the lines of the way they coded the original game makes it hard to, you know, recode over, I guess.
Watch your back. Okay, that's interesting.
So, like, I mean, in part, it's the people who compiled the games not doing that great of a job, but also the, just the way that they were originally made was meant for the PS2 and not anything else.
Yeah, I guess they were a bit too ambitious sometimes there. The graphical, you know, trying to push the engine to PS3 graphics, I guess they were a bit too ambitious.
It's not even really that so much, it's just, I don't know, it was intended for one thing and then it's trying to be used for another.
That makes sense as well, yeah.
You don't sell the steak, folks, you sell the sizzle. I sold the sizzle, guys. Also, I upgraded my Leviathan.
And Ratchet is hot.
Ow.
Security, all activated, sir. Ready for your next order.
Hack them orbs, guys. You gotta, like, hack all the orbs so that I live.
I've always wondered about Ratchet and Clank games. I've never actually played one, so I wouldn't know. But isn't it annoying having to watch your ammo with the amount that you're given?
Well, a lot of times it's just you have to remember you have other weapons. You gotta remember to switch every so often.
Look, if you want to keep using the flail, then you've only got 25 to work with, so you can't just...
Well,
I guess that's
that
a good thing,
you gotta,
but
you gotta look
I don't
out
know,
for
I
ammo crates.
If it was my favorite weapon, I wouldn't want to feel like I could use it as a crutch if I wanted to.
Well, the flail is something you'd usually just use for big groups of enemies on the ground anyway, which this challenge is mostly consisted of that. You know, I'm not gonna lie, actually, about the buffering, but I have a theory about why that might be.
You know, I have no problem with the stream itself, but for some reason, in the Skype call, it keeps fading you in and out. I'm not sure if it's my connection or your connection or whose connection.
People keep saying
it does it to everyone every stream, no matter who's hosting.
People keep saying it cuts out. I have a feeling that's just because I'm streaming. Okay, here's what I'm gonna do, guys.
Because we had Bobby Host who does it, Dragon Host who does it.
Okay. If you're having trouble with the stream, try refreshing it. See if that help. Well, refreshing the page, the stream page. Otherwise, you may want to leave it alone. I was trying something because Dragon suggested a thing, and I don't know if it's really gonna work or if it is working or whatever it even does.
Oh, damn it!
The arena challenge brings us back to the days of classic arena combat, an old-fashioned arena deathmatch.
That was working so well
just
too.
Like Mom used to make.
Mom used to make lots of arena death matches, don't you know? Oh gosh, is the next planet the snow one, or is that later? I'm not ready for Char, man.
Dang it. Huh.
Plus, this game also gives you a lot of ammo, so you almost never run out as long as you keep switching occasionally.
I wonder if you'll see any really good remakes on the Wii U.
Remakes of what?
I'd love to see a Super Mario Sunshine one, but it, although arguably it's not necessary. But...
Yeah, Sunshine's pretty cool.
Yeah, they are remaking Wind Waker, so I mean, Sunshine in HD would look glorious, I would imagine.
And that's one game where you could use lots of bloom and get away with it, because it's supposed to be kind of a bright game.
Yeah. Personally, I wish Sunshine would just kind of die off, but, you know, hey, if more people want it, why not?
Yeah. I mean, if they didn't release a remake for Sunshine, I wouldn't be too fussed to tell you the truth, but if they do release one, you could probably bet that I'll buy it and play through the game again. Hey, if they even if they add some actual bonus content, that'll be nice. I think one thing as well that Nintendo are worried about is the fact that it's not worth the time and all their money.
Will that guy over there, like, die ever? That'd be great. Oh, I switched to the vaporizer on accident. That's what I wanted to do, clearly. Man, this challenge just doesn't want to end. Oh, well, now it wants to end. Okay. Oh, good, I get to go to the Avenger tournament. Whoa. But personally, like, this game isn't a very good indication of what the Ratchet series is like. So... I got the Ace Hardlight Exterminator card! Yay!
Quake, did you see me out there against that shell shot guy? Yeah, I saw.
You worry me. Ratchet, you missed the part where you died a bunch of times and ate lots of popcorn.
Do you realize how many other heroes they have killed?
What the?
Here, watch this.
And now for a Vox News action update.
The new season of Dread Zone is underway, and on pace to break ratings records once again.
That was funny. The
notorious mafia crime boss known as Ratchet. I'm not gonna lie, I like all the stuff that they do in this game where they make Ratchet just seem like this horrible person.
What the?
But it's so blatantly obvious that it's made up.
That's a...
It's kind of funny.
That picture in the background looks really forced.
I know, that's why it's hilarious.
And really funnily drawn, too. Oh my god, Evil Clank. What? No, it looks like someone just drew on the picture with paint or something.
I know!
No, it's completely legitimate.
That's what Clank looks like on a regular basis, don't you know?
See, look, they'd never lie to you, they're the news. I like how he's just being standing around in the chair, that's great.
Yeah,
no, really, they should have that picture.
Like...
They should use all those pictures for the Seems Legit meme, because it totally fits that.
Like, Dallas and Juanita pretty much make this game. I mean, I'm glad that they at least kept the humor around.
Yeah, that's kind of nice.
Well, or at least they try. That's exactly what it is, Furball.
And you're going to be the star of my highlight reel. Hey, look, it's Ace Dingledang.
I like that guy. Can I just kill him now and save some time? I know you're busy with the
fighting and the jumping and the hurting. His hair is like a ice pick.
Ooh, I got a spinny thing. So, I guess I should probably point this out. The card thingies that I got here, like, you can get them for doing certain objectives. They're kind of like the trophies from the previous game. Can't get them until challenge mode, though. Oh, good, I can buy the Dreadinator. So this is probably the last upgrade to the thing. It's pretty cheap, so I'm just going to go ahead and get it.
What's this game's equivalent of the Rhino?
The Harbinger. I don't have it
the
yet,
what?
Though. The Harbinger, the hair, it brings you lots of hair.
That sounds like a fun and a half.
Yeah, it's this one.
Man, I remember first playing that game when I was sick and getting the Rhino. Oh man.
I know, right?
So
the Rhino was
nice.
Pretty sweet. Gosh, I don't know which one to get next. It hardly matters, but if I could, I'd actually really like to get the rocket launcher, but I guess I could settle for the rifle. In fact, I'm just going to get that now since I have enough money for it. Might as well.
I would think that a rifle would be useless in this, considering that this game is all about area of effect abilities.
It's useful in certain situations, though.
Oh, okay. I guess you can switch to your rifle and then switch back to your own.
Well, like, the other thing is those shields that I have. Like, if you use the shields in combination with the rifle, you know, you can kind of just sit there and shoot everybody to death.
It'd still be cool, though, if the rifle did, like, a tiny bit of splash damage to at least
it
compensate for punishing you for using it.
No, it actually does. As a knife. Like, where it hits, it kind of explodes a little.
Oh. Well, that's kind of neat, then. Okay, that's a nice weapon.
Also, I think it goes through enemies, too. I don't know.
Huh. That's a little bit better than what I was imagining, then. Also, Game Guy, I've been meaning to ask you for a while, but I keep forgetting. What's your opinion on just Sonic games in general, new and old? Just think about Sonic 06.
Well, that's, I like a lot of Sonic count. Games. Really. I don't have a problem with the vast majority of them. Like, even some of the ones that are, like, generally considered bad.
Sonic 06.
Well, I've never played Sonic 06. I don't own any of the consoles Sonic 06 is on.
Well, I have a 360, and I played it, and I almost... No. I just don't want to ever experience something like that again. Like, I know everyone's like, oh, it's bad. And everyone goes, yeah, it's like the worst game ever made, but Man, it's bad. They did a good job at screwing it.
They did a good job at doing basic a bad things. Job. Up. Oh gosh, I hate these guys.
You should play it sometime, just to experience it.
Yeah, I know. I probably will at some point, maybe, but... Oh yeah, it's on PS3, isn't it?
I believe it has a PS3 port, yeah. I played it on the 360, though.
If it's on the PS3, I could try to find it at some point. Did you feel that,
Juanita? I don't think Sonic 06 was ever ported to Steam, no. But it is on the PS3, apparently, so there you go.
Damn it.
And see what speed Doctor said.
Thing.
He was flying through silver box the entire time. I would love to do that. The problem is, my experience was it just there was no control over where I was going. I didn't get any cool glitch, just like buzzing out and stuff. I just bad at that. Of course it
everything
been
I've
good.
Heard
could've
about
been a
Sonic 06
kind of
makes it seem like just a silly game in general.
Because it was like, alright guys, we gotta get this out by Christmas, and they're like, but it's not ready. And they're like, release the hounds, and then that game came out.
Oh gosh, I sneezed myself to popcorn. Ugh.
How do you sneeze and get popcorn?
Because I sneezed and it distracted me enough to die. Get ready to
watch Team Darkstar. Way to go.
How do you ice skate in a volcano?
How don't you ice skate in a volcano is what I want to know.
I guess I'll find out someday. Let's visit a volcano. Put a bungee suit on. Or put one, even better, put one of those wing suits on. Like the underarm wing things and glide down. To the center of a volcano with ice skates on. Just hope.
Oh my god, where the hell is this thing?
Somewhere.
Oh, yeah, of course, I get run over by an enemy immediately.
I'm trying to use this rifle a little bit, but it's gonna be hard when I have to use it on groups of enemies, because it does kind of explode, but said explosion isn't very big.
Yeah.
Oh, jeez, you can see me from way over there. Dang it, draw distance, you're like not helping me here.
Oh, get out of the way.
Half the time, I don't even know what hits me, I've noticed. Like, just suddenly I'll take damage from something, somewhere, for no reason. It's just really weird.
Will the person driving a mint green Man Ray 5 please report to security? You're parked in my space!
I think a lot of that has to do with just the fact that there's a lot going on screen, so it's kind of hard to tell.
Yeah, I kind of tend to not like games that have too much action going on the screen. When it doesn't cause it.
Get out of here again.
It's funny, because you know what else? Like, I was reading this FAQ not that long ago about this game when I was doing the skill point stuff that basically said that the shield launcher was useless and you'll never use it much. And it's like, are you kidding? If you don't use it, you're gonna get hit by everything.
Yeah. Like, whenever I watch you play, whether it be in the LP or here, you use it all the time, then I can see why.
And it's just like, come on,
okay,
man.
This is ridiculous.
Like, as a weapon, I mean, yeah, of course it's terrible.
By the look of it, if that's true, if they didn't use the shield too much, then they must be like champion Toho players that are playing this game.
Well, yeah, I don't know. This game is, I'm not sure how much longer this game's gonna take, but we're definitely not gonna be done tonight. We're gonna make good headway, though, I'm pretty sure. Because the game starts to pick up after this point, actually. It's kind of slow at first.
I'm actually surprised that Insomniac ended up making this minigame. I thought the franchise would have just kind of blown over after the second one.
Well, people obviously liked it enough.
Yeah, it's a nice... Well, Ratchet and Clank are nice enough characters, so... Yeah.
If Ratchet was a tough cookie, what kind of cookie would he be? I'm gonna go with Snickerdoodle.
Wait, is he here?
No.
What? Oh, I can't.
There's enemies behind
you. Know what
me.
I'm imagining in this like little section here in Game of Guy? I'm just imagining a Super Mario Sunshine bonus level music playing. Where it goes. With like a turning platform. That's exactly what I'm thinking of.
I know, I agree. The Super Mario Sunshine bonus level music fits basically any platforming thing.
Yeah, I love that though. I love those little bonus levels.
Those are some of the best parts of the game, actually.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to agree with that.
Just, I don't know.
My gosh.
Whoa! Hi there, guys! Immediately.
Also, am I, like, the only person in the world who didn't mind collecting those two coins in the very last level?
I never really had huge problems with it either, actually.
Just like, everyone I talk to about the game, their opinions on is always like, complains that they had problems with it. And I'm just like, take your time.
Well, that's basically it. People don't take their time or something.
Yeah. It's like, there's bits that went really hard for everyone as well. Like the only bit that was really hard, I actually struggled in Super Mario Sunshine, was the mission where in Pianta Village, where the whole place is covered in lava goop.
Yeah, that one is kind of silly.
I had a hard time with that.
Oh man, I get to go to planets or whatever.
Also, I don't know what makes me talk about this game so much when we're playing Deadlocked. Selling cigarettes to children, Ratchet went on to pilot a tanker ship for Zaxxon. A week later, Ratchet got drunk and crashed his tanker into the ocean world of Equados. Who can forget these graphic images of after making his fortune from selling cigarettes to children, that's great.
Hey man, there's a good market in that.
I love the writing in these games. I always have. What? Al,
how can you believe these ridiculous lies? Okay, I think.
Come on, guys. We need to get out of here before we all wind up dead. What's the plan?
I have been chatting with a tech droid on the operations level. She may be able to provide the blueprints for these deadlocked collars.
That's great.
But we must be very careful. Fox has eyes everywhere.
You know, if these characters are like constantly on TV and whatnot, how is it that we're able to sneak around and get blueprints to the collars we're wearing?
Sometimes
you got stuff like that. I don't know, man. I don't know.
Hey, it's not over here.
Cam, that's not a good game to play at all.
It's fun. We'll play it right now. 3, 2, 1, go.
No! Stop breathing forever is a terrible game.
I can't do it, game guy. I'm so bad.
This challenge mode is downright nasty, Juan. You know you fail when you can't even kill yourself properly. That really should be a motto of life, by the way.
Oh yeah, this is the one where I have to not get hit the whole mission, which means I'm doomed.
You know, my motto is always, if you can't kill yourself properly, you should probably kill yourself.
But Cam,
wait
a minute.
Never mind.
man. Cam the man strikes again.
Cam, well, he'll never be dead then.
He's more of a man than a Cam.
It's this nice infinite loop of aww.
It's right there, dang. His own shoes, his own fat burning. Wait, where's this fire?
Yay, I upgraded a thingy!
First of all, I should probably... clear the area a little bit. Here we go.
Australia's not a terrible place to live, it just has terrible people. Named Cam the Man. Oh man, guys, I beat the level. Amazing.
Okay, I better have my weapons ready.
I like how there's, like, no indication of you beating the level. It just kind of fades and goes, you win at the video game! The Butcher of
Bogan has this is the wrench-only challenge. Juanita. He starts the round with
only a wrench for protection. Wait, how am I...
This is the obligatory wrench-only challenge, guys! Heck yeah! Also, should point out I have the Super Morphing Freeze Wrench cheat on, so this is gonna be cool. Which is why most enemies seem to be on fire and frozen at the same time, because it makes sense. Although I don't see any of the morphing part, but okay, whatever.
Oh, this is more fun than a busload of cheerleaders!
Oh my god, this weapon's so awesome.
Which weapon is that, Bobby?
I get a weapon called the Peacemaker.
Heck yeah, I love that one.
Which murders everything.
Really?
Ratchet is looking it's kind weird. Of ironic, but...
Yeah, wow, this guy just does not want to die. That, actually. Hooray! There was some morphing, finally. Not to be confused with morphine.
The entire Earth is not a morphing.
Oh gosh.
How do you feel?
Dang it, these freaking lasers, man. They have too much health.
Alright, let me ask you a super serious question, game guy.
What question could it be?
If the entire atmosphere was filled with morphine, how would you feel about that?
Dead.
Yeah. See, that's too deep. That's so serious, man.
Well, you kinda, you would be, you know.
Yeah.
I hate how throwing the wrench is in this game, because if you hold the button too long, it goes into first person mode, which is really kinda jarring, especially if it just happens for like a split second. Because it just...
Aye. Yeah, I know what you mean. I can see what you mean. It doesn't look fun.
That's what I don't get about this game, is they just drastically changed all the controls for no reason. There was nothing wrong with what they had before.
Adding dragon.
I guess because the design of the game changed, they sort of panicked and were like, well, we can't use the old format anymore because there's too many guys on the screen and they all go pew-pew, so we gotta do something else, guys. And they goofed a little, not too much. I mean, it's not horribly gone wrong as far as I can see.
I mean, the game is fun, but there's just so many things that they changed that I don't understand why they changed. I need to get rid of this stupid laser. But it has so much freaking health that my wrench is not that powerful in challenge mode in the slightest.
This game seems to me that health is abundant enough in it. Not as a pickup, but just in general, because you lose a huge chunk of health if you even get hit once.
Well, that's because it's challenge mode. It doesn't do that normally.
Oh, okay. Because, like, you get hit by one little projectile and you lose at least, like, 20 points.
Because when it's not challenge mode, like, a lot of these little guys wouldn't do very much damage at all.
Hmm. I just think the four nanotech spheres were like the easiest, most simplest thing to understand. And then complicating it with numbers like 88. That's what I always hate as well. That's why I didn't think about a lot of Final Fantasy games.
Well, see,
is that they complicated it a little too much, the numbers and stuff.
I might as well die at this point. Screw. Remember, don't try any. The other problem, and this, they kind of started this in the third game, is a lot of the damage you take from enemies is actually percent based. So, like, having more health really has no impact on the game whatsoever.
I don't know whether it's just my brain, but I find four spheres easier to understand than 88 points. Just because it's associated with spheres or something, I don't know.
Well, I don't know. You gotta remember also there's like an HP bar too, so.
Cause like, when I'm playing the game, I look up the top of the screen on the first stretch and click, and like, okay, I have three spheres left out of four. If I get one sphere, my health will be full. And then with this, I have to look up and register that for a bit, and register that information to go, okay, I have 67 points. Now if I get one singular power up, I get what, like 15 health back. Then you have to add those up, whereas having like four is simpler to roll.
Dang it, freaking.
Also, hi, Dragon. Sorry I interrupted you.
Oh, okay, cool. From there, I didn't think anyone heard me.
Hi.
Yeah, I was just in the middle of me ranting about how my brain doesn't work properly in video games.
This one is as a planet. Everything's backwards there.
Hey, I actually killed the turret. Amazing. Except I'm pretty sure that's not the only turret that appears here. Yep, there's another one. Right next to the health, no less.
Sorry about that, I got interrupted.
Wow, there's like 10 billion guys.
Yeah,
here.
I don't actually have access to my computer at this point, so I'm just in a call, just chatting, so I can't see what anything's going on.
I'm doing this stupid wrench-only challenge, which is fun, because in challenge mode, your wrench is stupidly weak. Dang it, camera. You'd stop zooming in. That's annoying.
Oh my goodness, that was undoing me. Painfully one-sided.
How did you not go flying backwards? I hit you with the freaking hyperstrike.
Announcer is impressed.
Also, did any of the rest of you do end up doing a small amount of quantum physics and finally realizing why Captain Quark is called Captain Quark?
No.
It's hilarious once you find out.
Why?
It's because of science. No, it's because, you know you have protons and neutrons and all that jazz, yeah?
Uh-huh.
Well, you get a different stream of those which make up protons and neutrons, and they are called quarks. There's several types of them which make up protons and neutrons and positrons and all that.
So basically he's less than the smallest particle out there.
Makes sense. Freaking lasers, man!
Which
stupid turret
hilarious.
Is the worst
it's
thing
like
ever.
Literally the smallest thing in the universe.
Oh, well,
so small.
Like
so small, it's abstract. Even.
Oh, that was painfully.
I'm gonna come back to this when I have more freaking defense or something, because this is getting kind of stupid. Because I don't even have to do this one. No, I wanna.
Oh man.
I'm gonna go to Char.
Oh man.
Oh. Oops.
More health, more defense, blah blah blah, because this is getting dumb. Also, I'm pretty sure there's another wrench upgrade I can get at some point in challenge mode, so that'll probably help out greatly.
Tonight on Red Zone, Team Darkstar embarks
get out of here.
For some reason your ship looks like cucumber.
That's because it is a cucumber.
Why? It does.
His ship is cucumber.
Somebody should just paint on the side of it SS Cucumber.
The SS Cucumber. Oh man.
I would name my ship the SS Cucumber. Why
or,
wouldn't you?
Or they should be soaked in vinegar and call it a pickle.
Yeah, it's a pickle, and it'd be like in a vinegar dripping off it. Yeah, that'd be mean. I would buy that for $500. That's not enough. Ratchet, hack
those security orbs to activate the bridge. I have to activate the bridge, guys. I've never done that before. A good long-range weapon which can be zoomed in to accurately shoot enemies from far away. Man, I can't kill things with this weapon yet.
I hope everybody's pee-pee because we're not breaking for commercial anytime soon.
Oh gosh, that enemy. I hate these giant scarab looking things. I don't like them very much. They're mean. They were mean to me in high school. They were all like, game guy, you're not a giant robotic scarab thing that shoots lasers. What a loser.
You know what was more mean to me? The friggin' beetle in Donkey Kong 64.
Dude, that guy. We were best friends.
Friggin' beetle, dude. Races you, and he laughs at you, and he makes fun of you.
Oh please, man, no. The Landstalker.
Please, no.
Hey, you brought him up. I told him not to bring him up, you brought him up.
I didn't say please off like he did so I can have nightmares for a year.
No, but
actually, I think you did.
Because you brought him up.
His laugh is silly anyways.
Yeah. I love
you
that
the sillier laugh?
If you
please
play that
don't.
Sound clip.
Please don't. Please don't.
Well, I can't. Come on.
Oh, wait, never mind.
Have you ever seen the Diablo in the pale moonlight?
Also, I love how much you dress the vehicle in this game. It's nice. The gunfire, the carnage, this
is Drizzo! I also like how I have the morph mod on all of my
and soldiers.
So
what exactly did that mod
we came up with ridiculous
turns enemies into animals.
Let's come up with ridiculous
explosive animals. I feel like the explosive part's important.
This guy is gonna sell a lot of commercial time, Juanita. Let's just pray we don't have any more wardrobe malfunctions.
Yeah.
EMP, please. No dying, please. I said no dying.
Jeez,
you're
guys,
not
stop
listening
dying
to me.
These bots just went down. Oh, too bad. It was the cute one too.
No die.
The problem I have with the Land Stalker is it's bulky and slow. It can also and most of the enemies, while stationary, like kind of are impossible to dodge.
Okay, so enough of this. Oh, you freaking soldiers. Oh, man.
Oh, man.
Wow, that's like the first time in ages I've seen an enemy use tackle.
What was that about tackle? Oh jeez, enemies.
It's like
Hi.
The first time in like end levels that I've seen someone use tackle.
Dang it, dropship, you kinda popped out of nowhere.
Oh.
Man, what? These dropships just don't go away, do they?
I can see what you mean.
Of course, there's like tons of enemies on the other side of this wall, too, which doesn't help. You know, it also has like a side hop dodge type thing, but it's like near impossible to use. Because the fire button is R1 and L1, and the dodges are the L1 and R2 things. It's just like, come on, really. It doesn't really help any. Let's see what I can do with the Land Stalker before it blows up. Probably not much.
Another thing I particularly like about this game from the impression of watching it is the really nice range on collecting bulbs. Nice. Gives you a lot of leeway as to your positioning. And because usually in Ratchet and Clank games you have to change your positioning to get the bulbs, whereas this you don't have to as much, which gives you a bit more of a leeway to mess up. Which is nice. Maybe I'm looking into this too much, but yeah, something I enjoy looking into.
What is shooting at me over there? Oh, it's you.
Have you ever wondered what's in the special sauce?
Wow, like 10 billion missiles from nowhere. That's awesome. Well, whatever. I can kind of just ignore most of the enemies out here now. Whoa, don't get stuck on a hill. Come on.
Oh, excuse me.
You know, sometimes I think I should have taken that job on Annihilation Nation. They've got a great dental plan.
Everything should, like, die or whatever, because there's, like, 10 billion stuff here.
Yeah, it should die or whatever.
You know, this is pretty much the part of the game where they just decide, yeah, you know what, we're gonna ramp the difficulty up for no reason.
As much as I like sitting here and watching video games, I'm gonna go have a nice healthy nap, so I'll see you guys later.
Nap? Why?
You're gonna nap in a kangaroo pouch.
Yes. Bye, everybody.
Bye, Cam.
They nap in kangaroo pouches.
Yes. Bye. And I will always love the game guy.
Hi, Cam.
He left right after.
Aw.
He gave you that wonderful musical performance and...
Well.
Just a wonderful musical performance, an Australian wonderful musical performance.
The next set of nodes have been cleverly concealed beneath these priceless stone carvings.
But like, changes or whatever. Historical
preservation. Future generations will look back at recordings of Dreadzone to see these historic sites blown up in high definition video.
Oh man, this mission here. I keep going to the ammo vendor to buy ammo, and I never need to buy ammo. So I guess it's not even an ammo vendor. Man, having this thing take forever to actually kill stuff is kind of bothersome. It kind of makes it useless, because you'd think a sniper rifle would be like high-powered, kill everything, but you have to sit there and aim with it first.
That's the point of a sniper, if it doesn't kill physically.
Well, yeah, I know, that's the thing. Like, how many shots does it take to kill this guy, and it's only got 16 ammo? And that's just one enemy. I mean, I realize it's the lowest level weapon I have right now, but still. Ah! Turret! That's not even remotely fair. How do you see me from there? I think Clank tried to say something there, but I cut him off, because you can totally do that in this game. And I didn't even mean to, so it's pretty great. Guy looks pretty cold. Oh no, he's dead also. What a terrible fate he lives. There are gonna be enemies spawning when I'm turning this bolt crank, because that seems to happen a lot. No enemies. Everything I know is a lie. Oh, there's always enemies.
Really kicking some proverbial butt. And by proverbial, I mean the, I don't really know what that means.
It means we're unstoppable.
Yay! I murdered a bunch of guys. I should probably get more ammo or whatever. Not that it matters, I'm probably gonna die here pretty soon anyway, because I'm, you know, so good at this game.
Pretty much.
If I'm remembering right, one of those scarab guys is gonna appear right there, and right on cue.
That was weird.
You know what else is weird?
Apparently I disconnected or something.
Don't do that.
Yeah. No, better not be happening again. I don't want to say anything, please.
Do what now?
Is that all you got? You're not sick.
Oh, good. Lasers. I love lasers. Oh, good. I love lasers. Probably should use this shield or whatever. You know, because I'm dying and whatnot. That's important.
Is terminating with extreme prejudice. It's a good thing we're out of range, Juanita. We are out of range, aren't we?
Oh man, I win! I got the blue medal, it's made of blue. I guess. I don't know.
This time, Ratchet is dropped into the
oh gosh, this mission.
No weapons. Whoops. Keep your eyes peeled.
This is not going to be a fun mission.
Throughout the zone.
What now? Yeah, this is going to go fantastic. You know what? I'm just going to run. Nope. Not gonna even do that.
God damn it. Can this, like, work now, please?
What's going on now? Oh, good. A weapon I can actually use. Oh good, a weapon that I died. Well. Mostly because there were missiles shooting at me or whatever. It's awesome. Little freaking guy, will you get out of the way? I didn't ask for you to, like, just appear in my face. Man, I am awesome at this right now. Shooting all the guys in the world and not dying would be great. Yeah, I'm noticing a pattern here of me just dying a whole lot. And making small amounts of progress as I go.
What the heck, Skye?
Man, I do not even want this weapon right now. You don't even know. Great, and these guys spawn, so now I have to deal with them, because they're kind of in my way. Blah.
You're not falling asleep, are you?
Will everything just stop, like, randomly hitting me for no reason? That would be great. The problem is I have to juggle so many different controls here that it's just not working too well. Like, this is one of those games where it's like I want to like it and I kind of do, but there's so many things wrong with it, I end up kind of just fighting with the game rather than actually succeeding at, you know, liking it. And see, like, I lose too much health on the way here, and I didn't even make it there because I don't know what hit me.
If you're having a hard time, playing a better workout,
you can
adjust the game's difficulty level whenever you load your game.
Does even one of these guys want to die? That would be fantastic. And then I ran out of ammo.
What I want to know is how Ratchet uses the bathroom in that suit.
Good, I got rid of that thing, so now I'm gonna run over here. Or I'm gonna run into that guy and die. That's cool too, I guess.
Oh man.
Pay attention this time.
Will everything just stop, like, shooting at me all at once? That'd be great. Hey guys, I died and also won. Okay, sure. You guys see this? Like, because I'm lying dead on the ground, but I also won. It's great. Well, you know, whatever. Oh good, this challenge.
It's time for some maximum vehicular destruction! Drive hard and blast everything in sight! You sell the sizzle and Ratchet is
the trick to this mission is knowing where the jackpot things are.
I wonder if the Landstalker's stick or auto.
There's gotta be a jackpot thing somewhere. You would think, but maybe not. I don't know. That's funky. Oh no! I don't actually have enough points. Well, that's a bummer. I thought I was doing pretty good, but the challenge ended way before I figured it would. Okay, fine. I was only short, like, 200 points, which is great.
Is clearly much too dangerous to be set free. He must be destroyed.
Oh man, oh man. This is the shooting challenge of champions. I don't know why champions would go through all this mess, but you know, some champions are weird, I guess. Wow, I think I have even less points this time than I did. Well, that's pretty amazing. Oh, wait, there's more targets over here, right. Whoops!
Jeez, can't get any targets now.
I almost forgot to get the targets that are right at the end of the stage. It's pretty amazing. Whack-a-Swarmer, oh man, a challenge that's gonna be not hard in the slightest.
This next challenge is pure madness. Swarmer madness! Let's see how many enemies Ratchet can destroy before time runs out.
Oh, that's right, mirrored. I'm going to the right this time. The problem I do have with this is the fact that I'm using a weapon I don't have the upgraded version for.
How much short are you to get the upgraded version?
I think I can buy something, but I don't remember what.
Ratchet's got this match on ice, ladies and gentlemen.
I was thinking I was going to be getting more money than I have been getting, and I think part of it's because I keep kind of just failing at some of these challenges here. But, oh well.
Run, Ratchet, run!
Although, actually, I just got a whole bunch of money from this. Mostly because this is easy to keep my multiplier up on this one. Because it's just a bunch of small enemies.
Fuck.
Robots in a barrel, a barrel full of robots. It's a robotic barrel. I guess. I don't know. You think I know these things? Because I certainly don't.
Okay, that fucking worked. I don't know why, but I suddenly dropped the call and I kept trying to get him back in. I kept saying, okay, I kept not adding me back in. And then it would rinse and repeat.
That's not cool. Yeah.
You're stopping at
10. Hmm? What?
Hello?
Hi.
You were stopping at like 10.
No, I decided to start at 8 again, so stopping at midnight.
Okay, fair enough.
Mostly because today has just been kind of weird. I mean, I'm not, like, tired in the slightest, really. Where are all the enemies at? There's one! He kind of just fell into the water immediately, but I also shot him, so... Man, I love that these guys are standing right on the edge so that I shoot them once and they just fall in. It's pretty amazing. Now I get to go to Orxon, where I can orc some ons. I'm not even sure what that means.
The galaxy know that wearing the right pajamas can give you superpowers.
Oh boy, sand attack spam. I love that.
Battlehawk can fly really well.
Oh, I love that part.
Sir, we have the latest sales figures.
Are you serious? I couldn't hit him once because he was spamming sand attack in my face. Now I'm gonna interrupt it again. Jeez.
Oh man.
Wait. On your way there, tell the lab to set up a focus test. Find out why this stuff isn't selling.
Man, these test robots have like kind of a terrible job. Getting all disintegrated and blown up and electrocuted and whatever. But I mean, I guess it's a job someone has to do.
We're here on the beautiful Blargian homeworld of Orxon, overlooking a massive Raritanium mining.
I do like how they actually added Orxon to this game, because it's like, this is that one planet from the first game. You know, by the way.
Donating a new mining facility every week.
Because this is that one planet that I couldn't go on without an oxygen mask or something, so. Yes. Well, do I want... Kind of want the rocket launcher, not gonna lie. I think I'm gonna keep going and get the rocket launcher first.
Oh, God, I can barely hear anything.
Aww.
It's definitely by my end, though. I'm using a phone. You know, this is what phones are kind of made for.
Aww. One of these days I'll be able to blow up a dropship with this gun. And that day is, of course, today, I guess. I don't know. Man, look at all the enemies that died over there. I like how that guy said, "You can count on me," and then proceeded to die. I totally counted on that guy. Not gonna lie, dropship, you're cool and all, but I'm not trying to aim for you. There's health and such over here. Yay.
Folks, we're halfway through, and I don't know about you, but I am ready for some more carnage.
Yes, sir. Hacking was my specialty at the academy.
Oh man, lots of enemies that I have to murder. I've never done this before.
No, you have not.
Dang it, freaking. Will you EMP already? It's getting kind of annoying. Not a nice thing to say.
Clearly, because everyone can hear me.
Yeah, they kind of can.
I kind of heard you. Now I have a crappy connection right now.
Don't go anywhere, they've only got one force field.
Oh man, this is... Oh, okay.
That's what I was trained for, sir.
Yay, I win! I like how the chat's just kind of talking about Pokemon a whole bunch.
Oh, gosh.
Oh no, it's no
node.
Our contestant must boost his way up to the second tier and capture.
Oh, that didn't even hurt. God.
And Team Darkstar
has
taken the first node. Oh, they really did some damage. Not kill me.
Not if I kill you first.
You know, Juanita, there's no need to get personal, huh? We're both professionals. Star is unstoppable. There goes no number two.
Wow, sure is a good thing there's a bunch of enemies right here. Of you. Oh yeah, well. Wow, there's lots of lag. Like, game lag, not, like, I don't know, stream lag or something, I don't know. I can just kind of run away. Like, there's really almost no point.
Number four. Wow, this action is hot. I could use a hand.
It's like there's really no point in just sticking around because I'm just gonna get shot at.
Okay, I'm back.
Hi, how are you?
Also, I. That kind of reminds me of what you said. Did you try what I suggested?
I tried, and I don't know if it made any difference whatsoever. I noticed a lot of people were complaining about buffering and whatnot, so I don't know if... Like, what does that do anyway?
It access point or something in Canada where there are a lot less people instead of like in the US.
Well, except then it's in Canada, so it has to go further, I guess.
Oh, it travels at light speed though. The distance doesn't really make a difference.
Well, still.
Showtime!
I'll hack these orbs while you hold them up, sir.
I know it works with regular YouTube videos. I streams might be a different case.
Yay, I got a Mega Anti-Matter Rifle!
Oh man, these guys are hot! Did you feel that, Juanita?
I'm loving these dual raptors now, by the way. Just because they bounce all over the place, it's pretty great.
Yes, I can.
Oh man, I won or whatever. Whee! And I think this is the last challenge in this thing. Well, until I do the dread challenges, I guess.
Hundreds of Dreadzone fans on the verge of obliteration. I can barely watch. What can Ratchet do to avert this disaster?
Those anchors are pure rarity. We'll need the Landstalker's firepower to break.
He's done it! He's freed one of the ships, but can he save the rest?
Boingy, boingy, spider, spider, boingy. This is another one of those missions where it's sort of like, there's no point in just sitting around. You might as well just keep going. That's actually a problem with a lot of these, I think. Just because, I don't know. Something I didn't really think a lot about.
On the edge of their seats. I tell you, nothing gets an audience's attention like the certain knowledge that they're all about to die.
Yay!
Mackerel, what a finish! That little Lombax never ceases to amaze me!
Oh, but I always like amazing people with mazes or something. I don't know, it's a pun.
Oh man.
Oh man, a pun. I've never done one of those before.
You have qualified for the crucial. I'm sorry, what?
I've never done a pun before.
Folks, we've added a special
twist
to the assault mode. Our contestant will only have access to weapons placed in the battle course. Good luck.
What's a pun?
What's a pun? You don't know about no puns?
Never heard of one.
Freaking, I'm trying to charge boot it up and you're not helping me any.
Ooh.
Ratchet has reached the halfway point. He's really tearing it up out there, folks. One thing about Ratchet, you give him any lip and he'll feed you a lead sandwich. You better believe that, Juanita.
There's not really any point in going over there. I mean, there is, but there isn't also. Sure is convenient that I'm getting all the weapons I'm trying to upgrade. Oh man, look who won. It was me, by the way! This one I'm kind of worried about, though. This is the other, yeah. Okay.
Oh, it's time to play Blargian Turkey Shoot! This challenge tests our contestant's speed and accuracy.
Just because there's so many enemies around and whatnot that it becomes problematic if you don't kill them all.
And you also have to worry about getting scores. Or, like, the highest score and whatnot, you know, that thing. There was a jackpot thing over there that I really probably should have gotten, but I didn't. Hooray.
Oh, this guy should have his own fitness machine, his own shoes, his own...
Like, I forgot there was a jackpot thing over there. Man, will you stop shooting at me behind there?
Stick or auto.
This isn't gonna go well, I can just kinda tell. Is there not a jackpot thingy around here? There is, it's behind here. Of course, I'm probably going to die this round, if only because I'm just not prepared, I guess. Yeah, I'm gonna die. Which is unfortunate because I'm at the end. Oh, and there's another jackpot thing over there. I didn't even see it. Huh.
Yeah, this.
No, I want to shoot the jackpotty thing over there. Freaking heck, man. Stupid freaking guy. Go away. You ruined everything. I wanted to hit this jackpot and then get all those points that were right there, but you didn't let me.
This is what they mean by gratuitous violence, Juanita. I'm gonna call my kids and tell them to stop watching just as soon as I have kids.
Oh man, Dallas, you're so hilarious. Dang it, I got the jackpot like way earlier than I wanted to. Where are those stupid lasers going to appear? I don't like them, guys. They're not lasers, but they're something.
God!
Something that wants to kill me. It's all that matters. Oh man, guess who got enough points to win? Guess who's stuck on a Quark Robot guy? Go away, Quark Robot guy, I wanna win.
Alright, let's go to the scoreboard and see how well our contestants did.
I did pretty good, I guess. Now I get to go to the Crusader Tournament and crusade it up. Oh gosh, I can't wait to fight this guy, because he was the one that gave me trouble in the LP. In a world where dreams come bigger than life, and passions run wild in the street. Oh man! Baby. Oh, Courtney Gears.
One psychotic killing machine dare to reach for the stars. This holiday season, Fox Entertainment brings you the heartwarming true story of one exterminator's rise to glory. From lowly beginnings as a high school math teacher.
But baby, I'm giving these kids the gift of learning.
Yes, you know, a deadly death robot was a high school math teacher, of course.
We're rich. I love you, Reactor. I was always there for you.
Share the dream. Live the legend of Reactor.
You know, I'd believe it. You know, wouldn't you say that your greatest teacher in high school is the one that could kill everybody with just a flick of the wrist? Probably not even that. I mean, I'd say that's probably the greatest teacher. You know, death by...
Or the worst.
Well, no, you'd be learning by, like, hey, you better turn in your homework, otherwise everyone's gonna die.
But I have a new bot upgrade for you.
I would drop the class. Oh no, but we can't have everyone die.
Is more dangerous than your combat bots. Bring them back to my shop and I'll give them some upgrades.
I don't want your upgrades, Al. Your upgrades smell like moldy cheese.
Ooh, I want the moldy cheese upgrade.
I want the rocket launcher, man. Oh good, there's that wrench upgrade that I've been wanting.
So Ginga, how many more upgrades you got left?
There are like three or four weapons. You're making me run back and check again. Let's see, three more weapons I need to get the upgraded version for, and then I need to buy the Hairbringer.
No.
Which I'm no doubt buying last, so, you know. Crusader Tournament!
All right, Red Zone fans, prepare for the ultimate showdown as Team Darkstar fights their way through the Crusader Tournament and a chance to take All-Star Exterminator Reactor!
I can only use this weapon. Awesome.
What happens when we force the criminally insane to use strategy and planning? Let's test this Lombax's puny mental metal by taking away everything but free-placed mines!
This challenge isn't really that hard if you just throw mines everywhere, because eventually the mine will become useful in some fashion, as it just kind of destroys the everything everywhere.
Whoa! This announcer is impressed!
Plus, this is my highest level weapon right now, so... This is just gonna further skew all my weapon levels.
Well, I just realized something. Both my sigilus never blinks.
Do I? Yay, I won. That wasn't really that tricky in the slightest, so, you know, whatever.
Ratchet is utterly doomed. We've wired his Dread Zone collar to 4 control nodes placed throughout the arena. If he can't stop their countdown in time, the whole audience gets a fresh serving of Lombax Pate.
Lombax Pate doesn't sound like something I want. Not gonna lie. And not just because I'm the Lombax in question here, but because it doesn't really sound appetizing in the slightest. Great how this thing shoots out like 3 rockets and everything, except most of the other rockets don't really go anywhere. They shoot off too far to the right and the left to be really useful, unless there's a big group of enemies up ahead. Plus, the further away I am, obviously, you know, the less useful that is. Wow, I made a bunch of explosions! Look at me, I'm like super cool.
Bad, but Ace Hardlight would have done it better.
Oh man, I like how I'm just kind of running through this game without much of a care in the world, which I think is why it's just gonna, it's not gonna last that long.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's Reactor!
In theory, anyway.
Ratchet, you look like a squirrel wrapped in tinfoil.
I am a squirrel wrapped in tinfoil. Didn't you know?
Gonna give my fans their money's worth. And, try not to go crying or anything, all right? I want this to look good for the camera.
Bring it.
This is my house. I'm gonna smack that stupid look off your face.
Okay, I still don't quite know how to dodge that attack. Like, literally, it seems like the only way to dodge that attack is to use the shield, but there's not much reaction time for that. Because he just does it kind of quick. Oh man, the shield launcher thingy, blah, blah, blah.
I'm gonna put you in a world of hurt.
Please don't put me in a world of hurt. I don't want to be in a world of hurt. Being in a world of hurt doesn't sound appetizing in the slightest, don't you know? Man, I'm really glad for this shield. Oops, you're dead. Something I've noticed that's really weird is that, like, you see the ammo that he dropped there? Like, what is up with the ammo drops from bosses and such?
What drops, game guy?
This boss drops like 10 billion ammo when you kill him. It's dumb. Cause, like, you can't even use it, cause he's dead. The thing just ends.
Please welcome our new Crusader!
Okay, let me try all the Dread challenges again. Also, because I think this is the tournament where I get that one Dread challenge that allows me the ability to basically level up everything ever. Not that I'm going to abuse that fact, necessarily, but... Yep, end zone. Oh, man. Attempt number two! Doing great so far. Comes the laser. Yay. The laser, me and the laser are not best friends. Well, I've made it further than I've ever made it before, which is great, because I'm probably gonna die at some point. As soon as one of those lasers shows up or something, I'm basically screwed. Also, these blade balls are kind of annoying. Guys, blade balls are annoying. This has never happened before. Oh good, a dropship. Those always go so well.
Oh boy.
Blade ball, die in a fire. Thank you. See, that challenge wasn't so hard. What are y'all talking about? Zombie attack? Whoa!
Tonight, it's Team Darkstar versus the Robot Zombies. The zombie team just flew in from Catacromb 4, and folks, are they dead tired? What?
Wow, zombies do more than half of my health and damage. Amazing. Yay! This is gonna end super well. Yeah, okay, that's exactly what I wanted to do. freaking everything. Go away. Ugh. I don't like these challenges where I can't just switch weapons, because it's kind of annoying. Because most of the time the weapons I seem to have access to are either terrible or just not really useful in this situation. Oh man, there's a Leviathan Wild!
Explosions are pretty.
Although I just noticed this is the one where I have to survive the time limit. Which is cool, I guess. Oh good, there's no, like, they're not just zombies. Now we're just gonna throw out random guys that shoot at you. That's, you know, fair. I get promised zombies, and you give me something other than zombies? That's totally fair. Man, this guy does not like to die. Also, I don't have a weapon, which is great. Because I'm also facing the wrong way. When did I get the pistol thing? I thought I had the freaking... I'm about almost to the point where I'm about to say screw the dread challenges, because I don't even have to do them, mostly. I think you have to do some of them, but you definitely don't have to do all of them. This is just getting a little ridiculous now, some of these.
Fuck.
Man, Bobby, whatever you're doing sounds like super fun.
Can you actually hear something?
No, but you're cursing a lot.
Why would you feel if you're driving around the middle of the desert and all of a sudden a giant spider robot pops out that's like 1,000 feet tall?
Not very good.
Oh, and you have to shoot it. What? No. No, don't go into the lake!
Oh man, guess what's level 70 now?
Oh my gosh, I have one thing left and I can't kill it because it's in the middle of a lake. This car is not waterproof. Oh, and now he's on top of a mountain, that's nice. Oh, at least this isn't timed like every other stupid mission in the game. Oh, there it is, there it is. Got it.
Hello.
Hi there, guy who's shooting at me. You're awesome. Hi there, zombie behind me. You're awesome.
I won.
Why do you get a giant spider?
I don't know, but giant spider turned into giant spaceship and just flew away.
Yay!
While on fire.
Yay!
Sir, you're on fire. You might want to not crash into the mountain.
Mountains are fun, don't you know?
No, he crashed into the mountain. Good job. Oh man, they're showing. Oh man, creepy music.
Oh no, not creepy music.
You know what that means?
Oh, my little metalheads.
I legitimately don't quite remember what part of the game you're in, so. Apparently, I got hit by a thing. I didn't even see it, but okay. Oh, good. I got hit by multiple things.
Oh, I should. Can I get some weapon energy? Put some weapon refills, please. I'm like really low.
I need the hiccups.
Oh.
Can I stop switching weapons? Like, I'm focusing on trying to survive here, and then just weapons randomly switch on me for no reason. Because I'll just run into something and it'll switch my weapon on me automatically.
Uh-oh. Okay, I see the reason for the creepy music.
Hey, thank you, I won. Amazing.
I think this mission that I'm doing gets pretty straightforward. It says destroy final boss.
Oh. I didn't realize you were that far into the game, but okay.
So this must be the final boss. A dragon with tentacles or something. I don't know what the hell this is.
Oh, alright, cool.
It just landed in the middle of a desert, though.
This is that one mission with a bunch of really big enemies. You know what? You know, I'm just gonna say screw it. I wanna get done with this game, man. So if I'm having trouble with the stupid zombie mission, I'm gonna have trouble with that one. If I want, I'll come back to it. Otherwise, I'm not. Oh gosh, do I want this or do I want this? You know what? Mini turrets sound pretty great. I'm gonna go with mini turrets. Always go with mini turrets, guys. Mini turrets are pretty awesome.
Ratchet, you have now unlocked.
The Valix belt. Whoa.
We're live today from the Valix asteroid belt, home of the legendary Gamma Energy Beam.
Gamma Energy Beam
was purchased several years ago by Gleeman Vox. Now, instead of guiding ships through deadly asteroids, it's the centerpiece of Dreadzone's hottest new battle course. And just for fun, we've gone ahead and turned the beacon off. Can Team Darkstar turn it back on, or will hundreds of ships crash blindly into the asteroids?
Okay. Keep throwing enemies at me. That's great. This is perfect ammo refill.
Heck yeah, man. I love ammo refill.
Because now I have, like, full power on my weapon. Oh gosh, laser.
I just noticed, like, the higher level the weapon is, it turns more and more purple. It's kind of funny. Wow, you take forever to die, Mr. Dropship. Shouldn't really be surprising, but Oh man, that guy died. Did you see that guy die? He died like the best guy who dies. Also, this is the level where I'm very terrible at platforming, so I'm probably gonna die a billion times.
This guy's gonna sell a lot of commercial time, Juanita. Let's just pray we don't have any more wardrobe malfunctions.
What the? Oh well. More free. Yeah, more free ammo.
Silencer. Oh man.
Laser.
Laser. Oh man, it's a flying pig. Oh man, it's me not hitting the grind rail for no particular reason. Awesome. I love dying for no reason whatsoever. It's always a great feeling.
Okay, this might be cheap, but
you know what else is cheap? Dimes.
Okay, this is gonna be cheap, what I'm about to do, but
jeez, Bobby, why do you gotta
be cheap?
You know
what? The game lets you do this.
It's pretty amazing how this guy is back here not dying a whole lot. It's pretty great.
Oh, good gosh, man. I'm gonna okay, maybe I should try. Oh. Yeah. Try keep giving me the ammo refill.
Cable LA Unsure to rescue. Amazing how I'm dying a whole lot. I know, right? I agree.
Oh, wow, how did I jump over there? Yeah, you're superior, except I can do one little thing.
Only one little thing?
Yeah, I can heal myself.
Oh, but Bobby, that's cheating. Something.
Well, getting God, this is the only time I've used it in the entire game. It's because I just now remembered I have it.
But Bobby. Isn't doing what the game allows you to do completely underhanded and cheating? I know, right? It totally is.
Not really.
No, man, it totally is the most underhanded thing. Because honestly, you're so cheap for using something that the game gives you legitimately.
He fired a weapon at me and then destroyed it with his own laser.
Oh, man. He's pretty smart. He knows how to get you.
Errol's a silly head.
Oh man, spoilers.
That's not a spoiler.
Well, it kind of is for the second game, but.
Well, if I don't. And he blew up his own weapon. And he did it again!
Wow, I didn't double jump there at all. Amazing.
Gotta love when the final bosses are completely careless.
Well, yeah, man, they throw everything you got at, or everything they got at you, even if it wouldn't make any sense to do so.
Okay, I gotta heal myself, like, now.
Wow, that's a lot of exterminator guys.
Awesome. Okay, you know what final boss is cocky when he says, "I see why I never lose," and then you shoot him and he dies. I think you lost.
You think or you
There's
know?
Hit the sky, sir.
I like how my bot's just like, "Hey, let's hit the sky, sir," and I'm like, "No, dude, hitting the sky is mean." Didn't they teach you in robot kindergarten that hitting people is wrong? Gosh, man.
Apparently not.
No one remembers robot kindergarten. Gosh.
No, it's a game guy. They don't.
I'm just gonna let my mini turrets do the job for me. That's all right with you. Thanks, mini turrets.
That node opens the hangar doors. Let's crank it.
Inside up to spin around in a circle.
I didn't sign up to spin around in a circle. Aw, heck. I love that line so much.
That's. What the heck, man?
It's when I tell one of the bots to go turn a bolt crank. Like, he has to spin around turning it. He's like, "I didn't sign up to spin around in a circle."
Well, yeah, you know.
Aw, heck.
Our contestant will have to clear the area of all enemies before he can land.
Oh, good. A hover ship mission. Those always go so well. It's raining bolts, which is weird because we're in space.
Oh man. Okay, no. Okay, that's an even bigger spoiler than the final boss.
What spoiler?
Ratchet, is this a bad time? I can't find my captain or careless.
Well, no one's ever beaten the end game Jack 3, then I'm not gonna say anything. No, okay, the real spoiler is Daxter finally got a pair of pants. No.
Heck yeah, man!
That's not the actual spoiler.
Yeah, I know. I know it's spoiler.
But that's something really funny that actually does happen. And his...
Legs in a way.
And his eye candy girlfriend, Tess, gets turned into an Otzel.
Oh man, spoiler.
Can't wonder what's gonna happen next.
What's gonna happen next, Bobby? I don't know.
Something I don't know, cause...
silly. It says there's a star here, but I don't... There's like no enemies here. Oh, that's right. The stupid animals take forever to die, and they count as not dead. Just dumb. That's another thing that's kind of weird about this game. It's like, when you morph enemies, they don't count as dead until the enemy, or until the animal dies. Even though the enemy is as good as dead, because it, you know, once it's an animal, it's not going to come back. It's not like they change back after time.
They might have to wait a really long time.
No, I'm pretty sure they don't.
I mean, a monkey banging on a piano will eventually play a very famous piece, but so by that logic, eventually they should turn back in enough time.
Yeah, I don't think it works that way.
Sir, I'm seeing pieces.
Oh, Ben.
That's my best explanation.
And that's the end of that game.
The game is over. There is no...
Well, I actually joke about what happens next because, well, nothing.
You finish it?
Nothing. They've never made a Jack 4. They've apparently tried to revive the series, but they don't feel like they keep saying it's not Jack and Daxter.
Well, there was Jack X Combat Racing, and that game was pretty awesome.
Game guy. Game guy, you know you can't fool me with sarcasm like that. I actually happen to own that game. I've played it.
It does have canon plot, though, which is weird, I guess.
And for someone who enjoys racing and vehicles and all that, that game, no. No.
I've never played it. I don't have any interest.
It's not really a Jack game. It's just got his name on it and the characters.
Oh, I know. It's a racing game. Just that.
It's spin-off? That's never happened before. Not spin-off.
No, I mean the PSP game Daxter is more of a Jack and Daxter game, and Jack only has random cameos.
Wow, the little guy rolled it off again. And here
well,
I thought we were
basically
gonna
the point of the Daxter game is it's supposed to bridge the gap between the first and the second game. It bridges the gap between the beginning of the second game and a little bit after the beginning of the second game, because there's like a... There's one of those 2 years later kind of things.
Oh.
And the game Daxter pretty much takes place during those 2 years. Or rather, just before, I guess.
I need to pull out Daxter and actually try and finish the game, because I got pretty far into it and stopped, and I have no idea why.
Because the game basically ends where Jack 2 really begins.
Ratchet, you are currently in a South Power Station. You must locate 4 power orbs. Hack the orbs to power up the station. Although, finishing Jack 3, I feel kind of silly. I feel like I should go and try and find the first two games and play them.
That'd be cool.
Because, you know... Even if this is a game that's considered to be the best of the three.
Well, that's arguable, I suppose, but...
Ooh, wait! The South Power Station is up and running.
Then again, I don't have much of an opinion on it since I haven't played any of the Jack games past the first one in like forever.
Oh man. And the sad thing is I don't have any opinion on the Ratchet games because I've actually never played any of them.
You should probably do that next, if possible, because these games are pretty good. This
Even
one, like Deadlocked is kind of weird, but it's pretty good.
This probably isn't the best example of the.
No,
that,
it's really not. Like, if you wanna, like, if you got the Ratchet and Clank HD collection thing, that'd be pretty good because it's three games in one. You know. Well, I guess that assumes you have a PS3.
Yes, game guy, I do have a PS3.
Okay. Well, I don't remember these things.
It's sitting right there next to my PS2, actually.
Amazing how that works.
They're both underneath his table right here.
There are the two security orbs. Hack them, and you will have the North Power.
Although the PS3 doesn't really get too much action, because I have so many fun games on the PS2. Oh, I can mark another game off the list here, Severs. See if there's any other random games I have in here that are funny.
Funny? Funny how? Like
well,
me dying
let's see.
Randomly? That's pretty funny.
What do we have here? Okay, there obviously must have been a time where I was like way too obsessed with SpongeBob.
Hey man, SpongeBob's pretty cool. Shit.
Cause apparently right after I saw the episode Atlantis SquarePantis, I went out and bought the game and never opened it.
Whoa, Bobby. How could you not open that? That's like a piece of SpongeBob history right there.
Well, Atlantis SquarePantis, yes, yes, it is. Yes, it is a part of that. I don't know why I don't know why the game isn't open.
I go 10 to 8 feet. Ratchet, you are currently in the South Power Station. You must
locate 4 power orbs. Hack the orbs to the station. Oh no, there's a lot of games I haven't played. I wonder why I don't.
Will the person driving a mint green Man Ray 5 please report to security? You're parked in my space!
Clucky Jr. and Clucky Jr. run to safety. This place might be deadly. Would somebody just kill this little runt already? Juanita, I know you love me. We're all green, baby. Juanita's just always like, man, I wish that Lombax guy would die a whole lot, and then I do. But in the end, I think she loves me.
Well, now that I finish that, I guess I can. I don't know.
Can you know?
Flip a coin and decide.
I don't know. I could sit here for a few minutes and rant about it or whatever.
I mean, what'd you think about the game as a whole with the spoiler-free attitude?
Well, I thought it was a. I actually thought it was a good game. There's. I think it's a little bit. I think the mission-based thing for me is. I don't know. I thought there'd be a little bit more free reign than that, but. I mean, even a deviated path where you can do two different missions and, you know, one thing happens and everything, you know, something like that.
Yeah, I suppose.
I'm just. I don't know. It's for a 3D game, it's pretty linear, actually, is what I'm trying to say, I guess. And if you're doing the basic missions, I mean. Two down, two to go, sir. Oh well, okay, because after the ending credits, and now they give you free reign. Okay. Nice work, boss. We're all green. So that means I can go around and find all 395 precursor orbs. Good God.
Have fun with that one.
I only have 205 out of 600.
Wow.
Yeah, oh hey, no, oh hey. Speaking of awesome secrets, of collectible stuff.
Speaking of secrets, though, there's a secret here. It's called Ratchet and Clank Gun Courses.
Oh yeah, that. You can like, I forget exactly, but you like replace the cutouts with Ratchet and Clank characters, I think.
Oh. See, I wasted those precursor orbs on that supernova ammo efficiency because I didn't even use that gun once.
There are the two security orbs. Hack them, and you will have the North Power Station up and running.
Oh, now I can see what all the hero mode. Oh, that sounds appealing.
Aw, but what do you got against hero mode?
I don't know, it sounds like a hard mode version of the game.
Man, I hate switching to that second ring in quick select, it's kind of annoying.
Yeah, so 395 reverse orbs, man.
It shouldn't be too bad to find them.
Yeah, except,
Well, Sharky, here's the thing about them. Some of them are just lying out in the open or whatever, but in Jack 3, there's this thing where you gotta talk to these statues, and until you do some ridiculous challenge.
Yep.
And then you do the challenges. Dang it, and this is a timed one.
Most of them are driving through rings and other such crap.
Yeah, it's...
okay, it's pretty fantastic.
Yeah, it's... and, you know... I don't have a problem with the challenges. It's just some of the things that happen during challenges are silly. Like, I've actually failed a challenge because a civilian got in my way.
Yeah, that happens.
And then I failed a challenge because I was trying to get in the thing, and, well, if you're in Haven City, there's soldiers shooting at robots and... or metalheads, rather, and they come flying in and hit you while you're trying to...
mm-hmm.
And I mean literally flying. Which is real nice when you're trying to use the jet board and trying to grind to get to something quickly and...
dude, I love the jet board.
No, I don't have a problem with it, it's just...
no, I'm just saying, I love the jet board.
Yeah.
Don't forget to order that Red Zone home game!
I love how I'm the perfect distance away to hit both of those dropships with one shot. It's pretty great.
Oh.
Bots, why you die? Stop it with the dying. Seriously, no.
It's so bright. It's like a light bulb. I know, right, green guy? It just wants to be evil, doesn't it?
This is the obligatory chain of swing shots. Whee!
One thing about Ratchet, you give him a
I agree.
You a lead sandwich. You better believe that, Juanita.
Wait, what? Wait, no, I don't want to try this mission again. Because there's a trick yet. Or, actually, I don't even know if that's going to work. No, I don't want to try again. No, it won't, because I can only use it twice. Dang it, they thought of everything. It's the only way I can think of to do this, though. Well, I can ride this little guy here. Oh, but now I can't use that.
Okay, I'll admit it. That was tough. I broke a sweat release hole.
I feel bad because I actually missed a whole lot of stuff that the bots say, like throughout the LP and whatnot. Because they say some funny stuff.
Alright, let's try this mission again.
They don't do it all the time, which is kind of a thing.
I'm not napping! I'm down! Yeah, well, thanks. Try not to get hit again. Yes, Drill Sergeant!
This is the safest way to do things.
People, I am beside myself, and boy do I look good. And so does Ratchet. We just might have a competitor.
We just might have a competitor to Rot-to-Root. I don't know what that means, but we might just have one of those things. I'm sorry, what?
I just said that I haven't either.
Aww. But why?
Because.
I'm gonna.
Actually, right, you know what?
Challenge.
I'm gonna go back to here. Because I know time extension's not too bad for a hovership mission. And a mission where you fly through rings.
That wasn't one of those missions where you have to go through the little. Where you have 10 seconds and you have to run through the things to save time.
Yep, it is another one of those. It's pretty great. Dang it.
That was terrible.
No, go down! And that's what screws me up.
Well, it was terrible because I kept thinking you had to use the flash freeze to help you, but apparently it wasn't that completely necessary.
Oh, well, I'm not talking about Jack 3.
Oh, this is more fun than a busload of
shit. Sorry, my word. Oh, ring challenge.
Of course, I have no idea where I'm getting bolts from because I'm not shooting anything, so.
Okay, this isn't all that bad. I think. Oh no, don't make me run onto the beach.
Dang it, no, I missed one.
Time to go to the beach.
I don't think my lizard friend likes this. Oh no, my lizard friend can't swim.
Lizard friend! No!
Remember guys, lizards don't swim.
Lizards are lizards. Unsurprisingly.
Damn it, I.
Okay,
you just gotta memorize where these are, I suppose.
Oh man, a cutscene.
Since you know, you walk through a ring and then the next one's in midair. Why are you freaking civilians? Can't you see I'm trying to pass a test here? Get out of the way.
They want you to fail.
I'm not sure they really know what's going on. Whoa. Oh man. The only time they know when something's going on is when you shoot them, because then they shoot back. Oh, there's the end. Yay. That voice is. I'm never gonna be able to take that voice seriously again.
What voice?
Like the deep voice that talks to you after you beat the challenges.
Do what?
It's. Someone said it earlier. It's a major spoiler and one of the funniest turning points in video game history.
Welcome back to Red Zone fans. I don't know. What are we talking? Are we talking about Jack 3 again? Because
yes.
I don't remember then. Ace Hardlight toy manufacturing plants. And although the plant was shut down due to shoddy sales,
one of Ace's ships still remains. Team Darkstar will have to find that ship. Well, I don't want to say anything. Well, not all the chats here, because someone said they didn't want me to say it, so.
Yeah, well. This, thing. It's a thing. I can buy the Vulcan cannon. Yay!
This thing, it's a.
I agree. But you will have to deactivate a force field to gain access to it.
Zone started out with two guys fighting over a breakfast burrito, and the rest is
what
history.
Is Me running to a spot in less than 15 seconds prove I'm a hero.
Don't you know? Running is really hard to do.
This game defies logic. Don't you run quickly to register a prize? I don't know where that is. Or, no, yes, I do.
Oh man, Quasar Turret Launcher is pretty cool. Oh right, I need to hack the orbs. Durr.
One more to go, sir.
Take that, Lombax. Yeah. Dang it, I don't know where the spot is. I thought I did.
Yay! I did a thing, guys. It's pretty great.
Oh, I have to be able to get to it in 20 seconds, that's all I know.
By the way, did for me to ever, like, answer you about anything? I mean.
Nope.
No. Oh.
It's right here.
I'm just curious, because I noticed he's still online, so it's just. Oh.
Nah, he's trolling us.
What a meanie pants.
A group of flying drones power the shields by staying in perpetual motion and transferring their kinetic energy. Even though I just read that off a cue card and don't have any idea what it means, I do know that Team Dark
really help if
the
orbs would, like, glow or something.
I don't know if you turn the wireless off on the 3DS while playing a DS game, you can't turn it back on.
Oh, and I found this spot. Great.
What now? Lucky Jr., you got in my way. Which is kind of bad, because that means you exploded. But... Speaking of exploded, I fell in the water.
Oh, what? I grabbed it right as the timer ran out.
This mission is kind of silly, guys.
Yeah, I give you hope for the future because I found an orb in less than 20 seconds.
Remember, don't try any of this at home.
I can keep going with that joke all day. It's... Never occurred to me how ridiculous it is.
Oh, there you are. I was wondering where the rest of the robots were. For some reason, they were just, like, not there, nowhere near me or something. I don't know, it was weird. They keep, like, stopping. Which is weird, because they're not really supposed to do that. Really? Really? I'm gonna die at the end? Again? Great.
Poor game guy.
I know, right?
This mission's supposed to be pretty easy, too. It's just kinda dumb.
Well, it's pretty easy.
Why can't you die at the beginning instead of the end?
I don't
know. Or not at all, rather.
This guy stopped again. It's confusing.
This game guy forgot his vehicle wasn't waterproof.
It's not my fault that they put water here. Maybe if I had a bowl of daddy flakes, I could go ahead and just succeed.
Yes.
I don't think...
Why do these things keep stopping? That's so weird.
Not think? Okay.
Freaking... Ugh.
No, I guess I could try jumping off.
Wait, what's this? Shiny? It's the exact same as a regular.
Oh, this is so... Oh. Get out of here, lizard.
Dang it, freaking
good. This shiny scyther looks just like a regular one.
That's because it is a regular one. You've been tricked.
But it has a shiny animation.
But you were tricked. Where's the last... Oh, freaking morph mod is probably screwing everything up. Come on. Wherever you are, little animal, please die. Okay, thank you. Gosh, man. The heck? Man, the chat and the audience in general is just kind of dead tonight. I wonder why.
It's because I'm not there.
But you are there. I mean, you're in the call, so technically, on some level, you are there.
Well, I'm in the call, but not in the chat.
Must be just like Monday night, I don't know.
Probably.
I'm just guessing.
Either that
people
or people
don't.
Seriously saw the title Ratchet Deadlocked and thought, nope.
Yeah, I don't think a lot of people like the Ratchet series as much.
You can just wait till the next game. You're probably going to have a million people there.
I'm not a fan of the series because I've never played it. And this game just seems ridiculously cliche and just kind of.
Well. Again, this isn't a good representation of the rest of the series at all.
I'm not saying it is, but...
Awesome! That guy, like, killed me immediately. That's great.
Man, that was...
No, I don't want to be in the freaking stupid thing. And see, because of that, I got hit. Thank you.
No, let's put the jet board away. I can't land on those roofs, and why does it make it look like I can?
Cause.
No, I can even fly above them. If I try to get down, and the game's like, nope, you're outside the boundary.
This game barely uses the gravity boots, though, which kind of bothers me a bit.
What?
It's like, why have a functionality you're not even going to really use a whole lot?
What is wrong with this game?
I don't know what.
Oh, I can sit here and fly in place and look like an idiot.
That's not very fun.
Are you streaming?
I'm just, this is terrible. The graphic on top is fun.
Freaking, really? Well, at least it's nice to know someone's watching. Because it seems sometimes like nobody's here, you know? It is kind of worrisome sometimes. Like, I go through the effort to stream and then nobody's here. I mean, I realize the call's here, that's kind of a given, but, you know. Let's be honest, the stream isn't exactly for the call's benefit, so.
Have you ever wondered what's in the special sauce?
Oh man, I got the shield launcher thing.
No.
From in here.
Freaking heck, man. Everything does way too much damage in challenge mode. It's annoying. So those guys do like almost half of my, well actually it's more than half of my health.
Hey, boss.
Wow.
And it's like, yeah, my progress is saved every time I turn a node, so I can just kind of move on to the next one and not have to go back there, but still, it's like, come on, really? I have to resort to just kind of a hit and run strategy. I don't feel like I should have to. But the way the game is presented, I don't really have much of a choice.
You know, sometimes I think I should have taken that job on Annihilation Nation. They've got a great demo plan.
Oh man.
Whoa! Oh man, I almost glitched the game. Jeez, Bobby, stop glitching!
Well, actually, I did. I got stuck, and then I used the jet board to cause a glitch to get causing it to fly out. In a really weird. I got launched right in the air too.
Yeah, last time I played some Crash Bandicoot, I kind of went through a platform and got stuck inside one.
You gonna stop shooting? That'd be great.
How did you get on top of that building? There's like... I guess there's supposed to be a ladder, but I don't see any. Oh god, get off the freaking...
Oh, come.
announcer is impressed.
Oh, wait, I actually succeeded in doing the thing.
Absolutely unbelievable, folks! Ratchet has defeated the Torval battle course and escaped from the planet's surface aboard a
space shuttle
inside the Ace Hardlight Memorial! Only on Dreadzone, folks! You can't make this stuff up!
Or you could make this stuff up. I mean, it's not really that hard. I've never understood that you can't make this stuff up line. Because you totally can. In fact, you know, somebody made this game up, so that already contradicts it. Just, I don't know, the concept doesn't make any sense.
Ratchet, you have now qualified for man, that was terrible.
The Vindicator Tournament, woo woo, Vindicator Tournament, woo woo, it's a train.
Even though it's...
Plasma Woman and Orange Comets. Now the low-seeded Lombax, known as Ratchet, has surged to the top of the Dread Zone rankings.
Frankly, I can't believe the little furball made
it. Oh, I see what I'm supposed to do. Okay.
He's a scrappy sucker, huh, isn't he?
Yeah, not jump off like that and endangered species and common disease. Hurt myself, but. Kids and...
You know what I don't get about this this tournament?
Holy
thingy?
Crap.
Like, they have these exterminator guys, and it's just kind of implied that nobody's ever been able to, like, defeat them. You know, I just... I don't know. I find it slightly impossible that nobody's able to defeat them. Especially
sure?
Since all these weapons that I have are in canon, readily available if the price is right.
Game guy, this is not the price is right.
Yeah, it is.
Do you want to guess how much this Omega class beam of destruction is? Closest one to an answer wins. You get to go to the showcase thingy.
It's game worth guy. A crap ton of pain.
Game guy, that's not the whole showcase. Just giving away a weapon.
Value.
No, you have to guess what the price of the weapon
is. Pain.
The Price is Right didn't exactly give away weapons. So.
Okay. All right, Bobby, I'll tell you how to do this. First, you guess a price, and then Dragon, you guess the exact same price plus one.
Game guy! No, yeah. No. That, well, I know that's how they normally do it, but geez.
And then Sharky, you guess the exact same price as Bobby minus one.
Wait, the only thing that comes out is
someone just
can't win.
One. And then someone just guesses one.
Oh, I got the Vox thing for getting
hero.
All the skill points.
We are
yay.
Detecting high levels of radiation in the containment area.
Yay! He has a weakness to radio? What?
If you reside next to or near Uranium Man, you will die shortly.
Oh, good. I get to buy this thing. This is the improved version of the DZ Dreadinator. It's better because it says Ultra. I can't read.
Can I bid on the one that says free? Oh, never mind. Oh, man.
I don't know if I'm gonna hit that many dread points. I'm not really caring about dread points right now. Oh man, Vindicator Tournament.
Can only be described as miraculous luck. Ratchet has made it all the way to the Vindicator Tournament. But before he earns the rank of Vindicator, he'll have to survive the Battle Dome's deadliest challenges yet, and then take on the Eviscerator. It's time for the weapon cycling round. This time, Juanita and I will choose which weapons Ratchet can use from moment to moment. Are you ready, Juanita?
Oh man.
Boo.
Not gonna lie, I like the weapon switching thing mechanic. Because it's pretty cool. Because I typically like to switch weapons a whole lot anyway, so it's just like, man, it's pretty great.
And. Well, but it looks like no one won the showcase.
Oh, but why?
Everyone's too afraid to bid.
Let's see how he bid.
One thing that bothers me about this particular segment is that Dallas and Juanita are constantly saying, like, here's this weapon switch happening right now, and then it doesn't actually switch until seconds later. It switches way before they say so. Because there have been a few times where it's like, oh, here comes the switch, but it had already happened by the time he was done saying it.
Very funny, Steve.
Well, yeah, there's always someone who's betting, like, one bolt.
One
bolt!
Well, I didn't know we were...
I mean, it could, in theory, be closer.
I bid two.
We're perfectly emulating the prices, right?
I bid two.
We got the idiot who bid one, we got someone who just puts...
I bid two.
I really love it when someone bids one and someone says $2.
I know, Bobby, it's great.
It's like, what the heck?
That's why I said, like, Dragon should bid your bid plus one, and then Sharky should bid your bid minus one.
You folks at home can dial the number at the base of the screen now.
Because, you know, that's fair. Weapon. I never quite understood that particular part of the game, because it's like, oh, hey, here's an idea. You can see what the other people bid after, you do it in a specific order, so then you can just kind of bid a counter, kind of. Like, if that makes any sense.
Let's see how he does with this.
Like, they should just keep all the bids secret until... Yeah, I don't know. I'm sitting here trying to figure out the prices right. This is the exact thing I was expecting to be talking about today. Man, screw Daddy Flips.
Yes, let's try to figure out the game show that has been around longer than... pretty much any other one.
Wow, this dropship has a lot of health. Either that or this weapon is terrible. I'm gonna go with the ladder.
It's okay. But since we're talking about the prices right, there's an old lady on the show who bid $9,000 on a surfboard once.
Hey man, surfboards are pretty great.
Surfboards are not $9,000.
Yeah, what do you think the price is of a box of Daddy Flakes?
Here, what's the first item up for me today? It's a box of Daddy Flakes.
No doubt.
No one way.
And without question, that has to be it. Oh, good! I died on, like, the last round. Hooray. Because the guy appeared behind me. I've noticed this isn't real weapon switching, because I seem to switch through the same weapons at the same time frame.
Folks at home can dial the number at the base of the screen now to vote for your favorite weapon. Here comes the audience choice weapon in 3, 2, 1. There it is. And that Lombax is terminating with extreme prejudice. It's a good thing we're out of range, Juanita. We are out of range, aren't we? Let's see how he does with this.
Oh, great.
Try this one on for size, you filthy Lombax.
I now present with some gentle piano music.
ask of you.
Okay, that's enough.
Oh.
You folks at home can dial the number.
Something happened.
At the base of the screen now to vote for your favorite weapon. Here comes the audience choice weapon in 3, 2, 1. There it is.
This is the part where I spam Mega Stalker Mine Launcher bombs everywhere. Oh man. You know, because I have infinite ammo and whatnot, so that just makes this stupidly easy. Seriously though, this is a terrible weapon for this particular thing. Cause, oh man, dropships. They have like 10 billion health, and I'm using a weapon that doesn't do 10 billion damage.
So, you know.
Man, these freaking guys. There's so many enemies in this game that are really annoying to dodge, and that's why I end up using the shield a whole lot.
Whoa. Man, what happened to freaking time tonight? Gosh.
I don't know, man. I've noticed that too. It is like suddenly it. Super late.
It's 2 minutes to midnight. Wow.
I ate it.
Dragon, what did I tell you about eating time?
In 3, 2, 1. Sorry. There it
is. I know, I've been playing Jack there, watching the stream and all that, man. I haven't paid attention to that. Wow. Oh, at least after this is over, I won't be all like, oh crap, I forgot something. I gotta go do schoolwork.
At least there is that.
Because I totally got all that taken care of already, so.
After this, I'm gonna take a nap. Cause I got work, like 6:30 in the morning.
After this, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm probably gonna just do more stuff.
Game Bridge. You guys take a nap. Oh, right. Well. Yeah.
Well, I wouldn't normally have to, but I've like woke up. I don't know. I don't feel like I can stay awake until like 12:30 tomorrow. So.
Okay, I see. You can't even call it a full night of sleep. That's man.
Oh, freaking come on! And see, I can't even skip this one, because this is like one of the like things I have to do.
Wait, hold on, what is it?
It's the stupid beetle guys and then the executioner guys that keep getting me. Well, and in general, everything else, because everything does buttloads of damage to me. Full buttloads.
Oh my god. Sorry, I just found something hilarious.
Hilarity!
Yeah, so apparently. No, I found a video, I didn't know this happened, but apparently a couple years ago this guy went around on the streets and told people to sign a petition. He didn't even tell them what it was for, and at the end, at the top of the petition, the headline at the top of the petition said, "I am a moron." That's great.
Dang it.
He got a bunch of people to sign a petition saying I'm a moron.
I am not a moron!
Apparently a lot of people are, though. Because they don't read. No, but seriously, it's like when you're... How do you not see that... Anyway.
Hooray! Finally! These missions always feel like they take way longer, but they actually don't.
Oh, what's this? Team Darkstar must dodge a massive bomb drop from a fleet of dreadnoughts? What psychos thought this challenge up?
Huh? What's that? Reactor and shell shock? I didn't even know they were friends. Say, did they use the carpool? Hmm? I'm sorry?
Oh, right, yes, let's go to the action! Should have his own fitness machine, his own shoes, his own fat-burning barbecue.
I totally should have all of those things that you just said. I gotta throw a bunch of shields all over the place, because then it kind of protects me a little bit. The enemies at. Not that I particularly want to know. Oh, you know what? I bet all
the
animals
the
are still being here. Is what's keeping the enemies from spawning. That's an interesting strategy.
They're coming to the bed. They're coming to the bed.
What now?
Under the bed.
I don't want to check under the bed. I'm scared of what's down there. Could be moldy cheese down there, man. People say I shouldn't keep my cheese under my bed, but you know what? I don't care what people say. I'll put my cheese where I darn well want.
Welcome to the matchup of a lifetime, Dread Zone fans.
Cheese game guy.
Sunshine, puppies, and chocolate. Oh, here's Ratchet.
Oh boy.
Well, part of that's true. I do hate puppies.
And hate your sunshine puppy. What the fuck? What? Hatred of sunshine, puppies, and chocolate?
Oh yeah, this is the flailing a lot guy, who where you basically can just keep moving and he'll never hit you ever.
Okay, that's hilarious. So, that's funny. Oh. I feel sorry for Ratchet, as Ratchet's, you know, completely winning.
Well, you never know. One thing I've noticed about these boss fights is they don't let you keep your bots, which I find really weird, because they let you keep your bots, like, everywhere else.
Let me tell you, nope, you can't break this game. I'm sorry.
Well, it's not like they'd really contribute that much. Oh man, this is American Vulcan Cannon, American Defense Amendment. And then, as if by magic, he died and exploded into 10 billion ammo again. Like, what the heck, man?
Eh.
Oh man, I unlocked a bunch of planets, including planet Maractus.
Make way for our new Vindicator!
I'm a Vindicator guy!
Hey Al, I got here as soon as I could. High length! Can't you see I'm trying to concentrate?
I can't see.
Doing? Clank, are you sure this is safe? It is an acceptable risk. Just need to close one more circuit. Now you're a genius. You did it.
I know.
And then Al gets shot.
No! Looks
like somebody. One more circuit. Uh-oh. Oh.
Put it back on.
You're dead, Ace.
That's good. I like that spirit. But save it for the arena.
Oops, Al is dead. We'll never see him again.
This never should have happened. It's all my fault.
It is all your fault, Ratchet. You're a horrible person and you should go kill yourself. The end.
Aw, Game Kid, why would you say such a thing to Al?
Now they're gonna pay for it.
Exactly.
Man, Ratchet is just like super angry in this game. Oh man, look at that, I got the Eviscerator card. Whee! Well, I think that's a stream, though.
Yeah, you've been streaming how long? About 4 hours?
Yeah, it's getting pretty close there.
Close enough.
Yeah.
Yep.
Then.
So yeah, I guess I hope whoever was even here enjoyed it or something, because it doesn't seem like a whole lot of people were here, but, yeah.
Yeah, but tomorrow, you should have more.
Yeah.
Tomorrow I'm probably going to finish this game and Pikmin's going to happen,
although I couldn't really see any of it, but whatever.
So, yeah. Tomorrow, more than likely gonna finish Deadlock, start Pikmin. Did I mention Pikmin yet? I feel like Pikmin is important. I'm gonna end up playing Pikmin. It seems like every time I play Pikmin, someone goes, Pikmin? What? Pikmin? I love Pikmin. Pikmin is a Pikmin! 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 Pikmin!
Pikmin should only take you a few hours.
Like literally, I say Pikmin and everyone just starts foaming at the mouth.
Because it's true.
So, yeah. Tomorrow, Arrested Deadlock and Pikmin!
Oh god, I'm foaming at the mouth. Ow.